season. Because
Chicago Stadium. Vincent Riendo will try and quiet the crowd tonight. He's in goal for the Blues. In 31 games, he has a record of 14-12-4, and Riendo has lost only twice in his last eight decisions. He's 1-1 against the Hawks this year. At the other end, 28-year-old Alain Chevrier. He's 16-14-3. Cloutier has started the last three games, so Chevrier, not a lot of work. His last start a week ago tonight in a loss against Boston. And Chevrier in goal tonight for the Hawks. The referee tonight is Bill McCreary. The linesman, Swede Knox, and Dan McCourt. First place is on the line. The Blues trying to rebound from that 8-3 loss last week as they meet the Hawks here tonight at the stadium. Here at the first period, Ken Wilson.
John Kelly, the Blues control the puck in their own end and get it out to center ice, and it's shot right back in by Bob McGill. With the puck behind the net for the Blues, Glenn Featherstone up the middle to Hull. And a right wing pass too far for Wilson. The other forward is Momesso, trying to harass McGill a bit in the Chicago end, but can't, and the Hawks dump the puck back into the St. Louis zone, and Mike Lawler back for it. Up the wing, past Momesso and Wilson, and the Hawks control at center ice. Bob Murray's pass intercepted. Momesso, a shot right on, and Chevrier makes the save on Sergio Momesso. Ryan Sutter, the Blues coach, says the key tonight to the game is to move quickly and get the puck up ice quickly.
Well, the Hawks did a great job of forechecking the Blues in St. Louis last week, and that certainly is one of the important things tonight. The Hawks are a bit shorthanded tonight. They have a couple of key players out of the lineup. Denny Savard, a broken finger. He'll be gone for at least another 10 days. Al Secord missing with a strained knee. And Keith Brown has bruised ribs, and he could be back shortly. As far as the Blues are concerned, Tom Tilly scratched tonight. Dave Lowry did not play in the game tonight because he has a groin pull. So the Blues missing Dave Lowry. As Blackhawk coach Mike Keenan yells instructions behind the Hawk bench, but Dave Lowry, injured player tonight, Ken, and the Blues will miss him.
And they face off in the Chicago zone. The Blues have Mongeau centering, Zezel in chase. And the center ice Eagles for the Hawks shooting it in. All-star defenseman Paul Cavallini plays it up the boards, not out. And Mongeau had a goal the other night against Buffalo. Clears the zone for the Blues. A race for the puck. Van Dorp and Zezel back in the Chicago zone. Zezel taken out in the corner. Mongeau centers to Paul Cavallini. Shoots, he scores! Paul Cavallini! Mongeau and Zezel do the work, and the Blues, a minute and 8 seconds into the first period, take a 1-0 lead. Oh, Paul Cavallini moved right in from the right point, and did he let it rip.
Well, the key to the goal was really a couple of things. Cavallini's quick shot went right through the legs of Chevrier, but Zezel did some good forechecking to dig the puck free. Got it behind the goal to Mongeau. He took a hit to make the play, got it in front, and Cavallini drilled it through the leg. But three keys on the play, good forechecking. Mongeau took a hit, made the play, and Cavallini let go a quick shot.
These two teams talk about playing good defense and playing low-scoring games, but we haven't seen it. When they've gotten together, Blues have a chance, but the Hawks take over. Their leading scorer, Steve Harmon, slap shot. And that's turned aside by Riendo. Puck kept in by Roenick to Gilbert, tied up against the boards by Roberts. Mahar behind the net. Yanni keeps it in as he feeds up the wing. Now Larmer from behind the net, tries to move in front, and a pass for Roenick knocked away. Larmer taken down, the crowd doesn't like it. The Blues to center ice, and Tuttle kicks the puck into the Chicago zone. Chevrolet into the corner, plays it up the boards. Mahar is there, sandwiched, but the puck in the corner. Doug Wilson takes out Steve Tuttle, Jeremy Roenick, and Rick Mahar there, and they pin the puck against the boards for a faceoff. We mentioned high-scoring games in the two previous games here. In early October, the season opener, the Blues routed the Hawks 8-3, and then 5 days before Christmas here, the Blues were beaten by Chicago 9-6. So when we've been here, we've seen a lot of goals.
Well, in the five-game series, the Blues have scored 27 goals against the Hawk goaltenders. The Hawks have scored 24 against the Blues. Three goals have been decided by five goals, one by three. And the only low-scoring game was back in mid-October in St. Louis, won by the Blues 2-1. So this series has not been kind to the goaltenders.
The goal, Paul Cavallini from Mongeau, his sixth of the year. And Featherstone back in his own end for the puck, clears it into his own bench, and that'll stop play. Mike Lawler on with Glenn Featherstone, the Blues' young defenseman. Boy, he has really come on. Glenn, only 21 years of age, great size, 6'4". 210 pounds. He and Lawler in front of Riendo in the forward line. Oates, Brindamore, and Paul McLean. And now Mike Keenan, the Hawks veteran coach, is going to match lines here with Brian Sutter.
Rather interesting matchup here. Adam Oates, the Blues' number one center, against Roenick, who is the Hawks' number one center, with Savarda.
Back to the point from the draw to Doug Wilson. He shoots it back in, and it's offside. Roenick is on with Greg Gilbert and Steve Larmer, Bob McGill and Doug Wilson. Larmer, of course, throughout his career has been teamed with Denny Savard, and they have been a 1-2 punch that's been magnificent. But magnificent also describes the rookie season that Roenick is having.
Well, everyone said when Savard went down with a broken finger, the Hawks would be in trouble, but Roenick has stepped in and done a very nice job. Although he slipped a bit lately, the Hawks rookie only one goal in his last five games. But he has been getting a lot of press lately. As a matter of fact, he's been getting so much press. We wanted to interview him between periods, but Hawk coach Mike Keenan said, no, talk to someone else. Roenick's been doing too many interviews lately.
The Blues control the puck. The teams have changed forward lines. Blues dump it in. Former Blues player Jocelyn Lemieux back for it. Chased by Hall around to Troy Murray, the veteran, out of the University of North Dakota. Dangerous pass. And then Hudson clears it ahead. Here's Troy Murray up the left wing. Over the line, a shot. Kicked out the save. And then a rebound. Troy Murray scores. And that ties it.
Well, the Blues lead does not last long as Troy Murray gets his 16th of the year. The Blues defense backed in a bit too much here, and Murray got one shot away, and then the Cardinals, since he got his own rebound. It's one thing to back in a bit. It's another thing to let a player get a second opportunity, as Mike Lawler had Troy Murray but let him go, and he got his own rebound and scored his 16th of the year, so the Blues lead does not last long.
At center ice, Oates gets the puck, moves in, two on two with McLean. Backhand shot, he scores! Oh, how about that? Adam Oates right from the faceoff after the goal, and the Blues now lead it 2-1. Is that amazing?
Well, that took 8 seconds as Oates gives the Blues a 2-1 lead on a bad goal given up by Alain Chevrier. The Hawk goal, Troy Murray is 16th from Hudson and Lemieux. The Blues come right back, and a backhander by Oates goes right through the legs, and it's 2-1 St. Louis.
Oates' backhand shot was tipped in front of Chevrier. That's what caused him the trouble, and McLean may have tipped it in. We'll have to wait for the official scoring. Blues lead it 2-1. Here they come out of their own end. 3 minutes into the first period, Oates over the line. He's knocked down. Doug Wilson in the corner. Plays the puck. Not out. Here's Paul Cavallini keeping it in. A shot turned away by Yanni, who takes Brindamore out in the corner. Then Steve Thomas in a crowd gets it up to Creighton. Left wing to the captain of the Hawks, Dirk Graham. Long shot and a skate save by Riendo. Dirk clears the center ice for Brett Hull. He'll fire the puck in. Now the Blues are changing players. They lead it 2-1. Steve Thomas tries to get it out of his end, and it goes into his team's bench, and play is stopped for the Blues up by a goal. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
The sun's coming up.
Wilson, John Kelly, Bruce Affleck at an explosive Chicago stadium. At center ice, Jeff Brown with a puck shoots it into the Chicago end. Ron Wilson trying to move in and can't. Less than 4 minutes gone, and the Blues already lead it 2-1. Hawks get the puck into the Blues zone. Jeff Brown plays it out through center ice. Ron Wilson races into the Chicago zone. Goalie Elaine Chevrier plays it behind the net. Fans covers up to Bob Murray. He dumps it into the corner. Momesso, the only one there. Behind the net for Hall, he's too well covered. And back to the puck, Jocelyn Lemieux, dealt by the Blues to the Canadians and on here to Chicago. To Bob Murray in the corner, the Blues hemming in the Hawks a bit. They want to do that. Now Lemieux up the left wing, shoots and well wide. Larmer keeps it in at the blue line, a pass to an open wing. Brett Hall takes possession and pulls up behind his net. And then Riendo covering up and play is stopped by referee Bill McCreary as the Blues got a bit careless near their own goal. Brett Hall, boy, what a year, sitting on 62 goals, number one in the NHL.
A new club record with 62 goals, and Brett Hall approaching the 100-point mark. He has 98 points. Only two Blues players have scored 100 points. Of course, Bernie Federko and Doug Gilmore are the two Blues to hit the century mark, but Hall only 2 points shy of the 100-point mark.
From the faceoff, Chicago controls. Doug Wilson, a wrist shot right on. Grabbed and held on to by Riendo. Paul Cavallini scored at a minute eight. Troy Murray, his 16th at 2:37. And on a deflection, Paul McLean bags his 25th of the year at 2:45. This is one of those games that you didn't want to be late for because a lot has already happened. Right from the faceoff near Riendo, Larmer in the corner. Featherstone on him. A centering pass and Tuttle intercepts. Tuttle with Gino Cavallini. And Mike Lawler up the ice. Shoots it in wide. Then Gino Cavallini in front for Tuttle and Doug Wilson. The All-Star intercepts. Larmer over skates and helmetless Doug Wilson to center ice to Larmer. Over the line, he can't get around Featherstone. But Roenick in the corner. He eludes Mahar. Gilbert moves in. Gilbert can't move behind the net as the Blues Tuttle intercepts. To Gino Cavallini. Now to Tuttle over the line. He shoots. Chevrier has it. Doesn't know it. And finally drops the puck behind the net and grabs it again. And the whistle stops play. 2-1. The Blues lead it. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
When you say taco.
In the Chicago zone, the Blues get it at center ice. Dump it in. And here's Manson. Dave Manson, the tough defenseman for the Hawks, drilling it in. Riendo stops the puck for Paul Cavallini. Up the boards to Mongeau. He can't get around Eagles at center ice, and now Trent Yawdy has the puck. He takes a hit from Chase. Paul Cavallini knocked flying. Chase runs into Van Dorp, and here's Mongeau. 2-on-1 to Paul Cavallini alone. He scores! Paul Cavallini bags his second, and Chevrier can't stop anything. And the Blues take the lead 3-1. Just 5 minutes and 54 seconds into the game. Paul Cavallini has two goals, and Mike Keenan has to be going crazy coaching this Blackhawk team.
Well, another great play by Mongeau. He got the pass from Zezel, came in 2-on-1, and just backhanded the puck in front, and Paul Cavallini went in on goal and beat Chevrier, who went down a bit early, and he'll be yanked here. But Cavallini gets his seventh of the season. And the Blues lead 3-1. Well, the Blues had a 3-0 lead here the last time they played here before Christmas and lost 9-6. So don't chalk up the 2 points yet, although Paul Cavallini is thrilled on the bench. He has played very well lately, Kenny. He had 3 assists in Montreal and already has a couple of goals here tonight. And the Blackhawks will change goalies. They've changed goalies 13 times this year. Mike Keenan has the quickest hook in the NHL.
Jacques Cloutier comes in with that 3.09 goals against average. Alain Chevrier, 3-6 lifetime against the Blues, has got to be saying, "Coach, I'm 500. I stopped 3 of the 6 shots." But Mike Keenan says, "Pal, you're in the wrong sport." And the Blues have a 3-1 lead. And again, this is opening up like it again will be a high-scoring matchup between these two well-coached teams who like to play it close to the vest. The Hawks are a decidedly improved team defensively from the last few seasons. And as play resumes, the Hawks with a puck in their own end. Bob Murray. Long pass at center ice, fails to reach Graham. Thomas tries to move in. Grindemore lines him up with the pass in front. And the save by Riendo on Creighton, who hasn't done much lately for the Hawks. He's in a bit of a slump after being very hot. Centering pass turned aside by Riendo. Now the Blues are very flat-footed. Graham's shot tipped away. Blues can't get the puck out. Now they do. Here's Brindamore, one man back, Bob Murray. And Murray steals the puck away from the Blues' great rookie. Bob Murray dumps it into the blue zone, and Brown will go back for it. Paul Cavalier's goal is 7th, his 2nd tonight. Fermaggio and Zezel at 5:54. Now the Blues ice the puck, and that stops play. 3-1, the Blues lead it. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
People across Illinois.
Cavallini has a pair of goals. Paul McLean has the other for the Blues. Troy Murray for the Hawks, but the Blues out quickly here with a 3-1 lead in the first period.
How many games have we seen where the Blues have scored 3 goals before this man? Brett Hull has even had a shot on net. Well, that's what's happened tonight. It's unusual. Ron Wilson moves in against Doug Wilson. In front for Hull. And he's spun around by Conroy. Lomesso after the puck. Upended by Larmer. Behind the net to Hull. He's grabbed by Conroy. Gets away, decked in the corner, Wilson behind the net centers, and the puck hops to center ice, and Featherstone will whip it right back in. The Blues putting a lot of pressure on the Blackhawks in the Hawks zone. That's one of the keys for Brian Sutter's club. No question about it. Don't let the Hawks move quickly out of their end and through center ice. Hawks shoot it down the ice, touched by Featherstone, and it's icing against Chicago. Some of the fans here felt that Gilbert touched the puck first, and Featherstone is angry. He doesn't like the fact that he was dumped, and Larmer says, "Look, you want to talk about it? Let's talk about it." And Larmer and Featherstone trying to get at each other right now.
Well, Gilbert's actually, I think Gilbert's the one who actually tripped him up. And Featherstone, a bit angry. I can't really blame him whenever a player goes back to touch the puck. When you trip him up, boy, that could be very, very dangerous. I was talking to Blues assistant coach Joe Micheletti at lunch today, and he said that Glenn Featherstone maybe has been the Blues' best defenseman since the All-Star break. The Blues very pleased with his play. It's, I don't think any coincidence, Ken, the Blues have lost only 4 times since the All-Star break, since the Blues called up Dirk and Featherstone from Peoria.
Joe Micheletti, of course, former Blues defenseman, does a great job helping coach the Blues, primarily working with the defenseman. Jocelyn Lemieux to center ice, fires the puck in, and Gino Cavalier back to take it into the corner for Mahar. His pass comes to center ice. Coming up to the 8-minute mark. In the first period, Yawning shoots it back in for Chicago. Robert Dirk plays it in the corner to Paul Cavallini. Pass up the middle for Mahar. Partial break. Cutting in, and he can't get a shot. There'll be a penalty. The puck kept out. Now a chance for Gino Cavalini, and he's checked before he can get a shot, but the Hawks are going to pick up a 2-minute tripping penalty. Now at the other end, Robert Dirk involved in a fight, and not only involved in one, he's the winner of a fight in one of the quickest decisions in heavyweight history. Before any eyes can focus on the match, Mike Hudson is beaten badly by Robert Dirk. So at one end of Chicago Stadium, which has seen its share of historic heavyweight fights, there's a battle with the fists. At the other end, Mahar almost scores, and in the meantime, a penalty. And in the meantime, we've played only 8 minutes and 8 seconds. It's already 3-1 Blues, so Bill McCreary and his crew and coaches Mike Keenan and Brian Sutter are in the middle of a lot of action here tonight at Chicago Stadium. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
So, did you break him, Rog?
Break him? I own him. That horse and I are one. We achieved a special kind of oneness. Man and beast. speaking the same language.
What's that? Blues lead 3-1, and they will get a power play here as Yanni gets a tripping minor at 8:02. Meanwhile, Hudson and Dirk get fighting majors, and they go off, and boy, did Dirk ever give it to Mike Hudson, the Hawks' young winger. In his second year in the NHL, he took on Dirk, who is quickly making a name for himself as far as the fisticuffs are concerned. So the Blues will get a power play, and the Hawks' penalty killing has been superb lately, killing 41 of their last 45 shorthanded situations. The Blues are 8th overall in the power play, 22.6%, and 3 power play goals in their last 10 opportunities.
Play resumes in the Chicago end. In the corner, Lemieux and Mongeau battle. Lemieux much stronger than Mongeau, but what a job the little guy, Michel Mongeau, was doing in the corner. Now Lemieux to center ice for the shorthanded Blackhawks, and he just plays it in, and the Hawks will change players. They have Graham and Troy Murray with Bob Murray and Conroy killing the penalty. The Blues at center ice, Brindamore. Right wing to Hall, cutting in against Graham. Behind the net, centering, and Troy Murray, outstanding defensively, clears it away, and then Conroy clears to center ice. Adam Oates with a puck, quarterbacking the power play with Brown, shoots it in, and Conroy clears it out. Up front, Hall, Mongeau, and the man with the puck. Brindamore leaves it at his own line for Brown, the former Nordique. Rink wide for Hall. Hall is hacked by Bob Murray. That'll slow the best of them down. Here's Oates. Right wing to Brindamore. His shot hits the pad of Conroy. Larmer gets the puck. Hall sent reeling by Graham. Larmer over the line. The Hawks shorthanded. Poke check. Graham, good chance. Wilson a drive. And Riendo robs Doug Wilson on that Chicago shorthanded try. 40 seconds to go in the Blues power play. Brown ahead to Brindamore in the corner. The Blues lead it 3-1. Still shy of the halfway mark in the first period. Hawks can't clear. Hall keeps it in. Pass in front, just fails to reach Oates. Back the other way, Manson. Right wing to Larmer. Hawks are changing. Over the line, Larmer, but in over the line ahead of the puck is Dave Manson. And the Hawks are offside with 24 seconds remaining in Trent Yawney's penalty.
Well, Riendo just made a very good save on Doug Wilson as Larmer came in with Wilson shorthanded. A drop pass from Graham to Wilson, and Riendo just got the skate on that shot. Riendo, of course, a bit shaky in his last appearance in Montreal in that 6-5 loss. And so far, the Blues have kept the puck down at the other end, out shooting the Hawks 6-5, and the Blues lead 3-1.
From the neutral faceoff, Roenick moves in, then turns back to center ice and sends the puck back into his own end. 8 seconds shy of the 10-minute mark, and Bob Murray drills it the length of the ice and tests Riendo. Blues have 10 seconds, a final rush on the power play. They're up 3-1. Paul Cavallini has scored twice for the Blues. Now intercepting is Gilbert, but it's offside. And there are 2 seconds to go in Yanni's penalty. Paul McLean has the other Blues goal. There's Paul Cavallini. He has scored his 6th and 7th tonight.
And Paul certainly continues to rack up the points. In addition, he's played very good defensive hockey. He's plus 28, which is the 5th best plus-minus rating in the entire NHL. And Ken, he's not the best offensively. He's not the best defensively in the NHL, but he's very good in both areas and one of the best all-around defensemen in my mind.
He's a very smart player, and there's no question about his heart. To center ice, Paul Cavallini dumps it in. Wilson can't clear. Here's Oates. Good chance to drive off the shoulder of Bouchier. He's dazed, maybe hurt. Back the other way. Hawks at full strength. Roenick to Doug Wilson. And give Paul McLean some good grades for back-checking, blocking the shot. Brown, 3-on-2. Oates over the line. Wets to the board. Centers, and it's out of the reach of Momessa. Kept in by Lawler. Behind the net, Manson. Then Lawler will get a penalty for yanking down the Chicago player who is back-checking, Steve Larmer. And the Blues now will be shorthanded. They're up here in Chicago, 3-1. This is St. Louis Blues. John, it's been wacky early. Steve Larmer gets the penalty for high sticking. This crowd and the Blackhawks can't believe it, but apparently high sticking occurred before Mike Lawler did anything.
Well, Lawler, all he really did was push Larmer off him, and I couldn't believe
when the arm went up. I thought it was against Lawler like the fans did, but it's against the Hawks.
So Chicago again shorthanded. Here's Oaks centering. Oh, a shot! Oh, and a big save by Cloutier. It hit him right in the chest. Hawks shorthanded the center ice. Troy Murray to Graham over the line. Wrist shot, stop, rebound. And Riendo stops that. Hawks are flying. They're down 3-1, and Troy Murray plays the puck back to his own end. And Bob Murray on with Yanni, Graham, and Troy Murray. Now the Hawks will make some changes. This Hawks club, as we have pointed out, brilliant while they've been shorthanded. Here are the Blues moving in, and Hall can't get it in front for Monjo, and it's cleared out. Winding up, Brown smashing it back in. Into the corner, Dave Manson, who's facing a possible suspension. He can't clear. Brown keeps it in to Monjo. Pass in front, rather weak, and Manson intercepts. Tipped at the center ice. Larmer, one man back, Brown. Or Lemieux, rather. Lemieux, a backhand shot right on Riendo, the save. As Jocelyn Lemieux was really flying and does everything but put the puck by Vincent Riendo. And the Hawks have had a couple of pretty good chances shorthanded.
They've had some very good chances. Lemieux had a hat trick against the Blues last week. Nearly jammed it under Riendo. Meanwhile, the Blues had one good opportunity on the power play when Oates set up Brett Hull in the slot, his favorite spot, but Cloutier made the save, one of the first saves a Hawk goaltender has made tonight. But Ken, I've noticed one thing about the Blackhawk penalty killing so far. They're very aggressive. Every time two of their forwards come off ice with the puck, the defenseman or one of the defensemen joins the play and makes it a 3-on-2, and the Blues have to watch that. But when you do that when you're shorthanded, that is a big risk.
You're definitely going to get burned sooner or later, but they're playing with such confidence while they're shorthanded. The other night when they lost 4-0 in Washington, they stopped the Caps power play 8 of 9 times. Blues on the power play. Paul McLean tips it into the corner. Cloutier whisks it up the boards and by Paul Cavallini to center ice. Backcourt, Zezel. Over to Momesso. And back into the Blues defensive end to Roberts with Paul Cavallini, McLean, Zezel, and Momesso on this power play. 20 seconds left with a man advantage in over the line. Puck dumped into the corner. Bob Murray, first man there. Clears it around the near boards and kept in by Paul Cavallini. Into the corner. Momesso battling with Yanni. It's loose to Zezel. Then he's checked and loses the puck. Here's Steve Thomas for Chicago. Over the line. Gets around Paul Cavallini, but doesn't have the puck. Now back on Larmer for Chicago. The Hawks are again at full strength. The puck in the corner near Riendo. Up the boards to Zezel. And cleared out to center ice. The Hawks are beginning to hit a little more now as this period grows older. The period 13 minutes old. Blues lead 3-1. Come to center ice. Tuttle can't accept the pass. Thomas tries to move in. Stopped by Roberts. And Paul Cavallini clears the puck back to Doug Wilson at his own end to Jocelyn Lemieux over to Dave Manson. Manson up the right wing, in over the line, puts on the brakes, flips the shot wide. And along the boards, the puck fought for by five players and finally cleared to center ice by the Blues. Manson having trouble with the puck, clears it out of his own end. And Larmer has it handed to him by Featherstone, and Steve Larmer just fires it in. The Blues have been outshot 9-8 here in the opening period, but they lead it 3-1. Blues to center ice, shoot the puck in, it may be icing, and as McGill touches it, it is. The Blues up 3-1 here in the first period. Let us pause 15 seconds for station identification. This is St. Louis Blues Hockey.
Looking for slapstick?
Certainly! No!
Yes! A little fun? Well, look no further.
I can hardly wait.
Night Court. Is this much fun really legal?
Night Court. Weeknights at 10.
The Blues lead 3-1, 6:14 left in the first period. Well, Brian Setter and the Blues have done what they wanted in this first period. They've taken the crowd out of the game, and can they move the puck quickly in their own zone, which really takes away some of the Blackhawks' good forechecking. That was their game plan going into the contest.
Face off near Riendo. Dwayne Sutter back to Steve Conroy. Screen shot wide. At the right point, McGill keeps the puck in. Then Mahar gets it and clears it out. Hawks at center ice with it. Bob McGill backhands it back in. Featherstone takes over behind his net, clears it into the corner. Gilbert there to intercept. Greg Gilbert behind the net, trying to center, unable to. Dwayne Sutter, and Tuttle sends an outlet pass to Gino Cavallini. His shot tipped by McGill, well wide. The Blues make a wholesale player change. Wayne Van Dorf in his own zone for Chicago to McGill, up to Gilbert, and a pass for Sutter too far. Gordy Roberts with a puck, starts out from behind his net. Blues up 3-1 to Hull. Stopped at center ice, and now Brown takes over. Rink wide to Roberts, 5:22 to go. First period, up to Momesso, over the line to Ron Wilson, back to Momesso, quick shot, the save, puck loose, and it's swept out of the crease at the last moment by Lemieux. Then a centering effort by Brown goes to the point. Momesso, a shot over the net and off the glass, and here's Dirk Graham. Clears it out of his own end, a bouncing pass ahead to Troy Murray, who drops it for Jocelyn Lemieux into the corner. Brown wedges him to the boards. Momesso ties up his man, Graham. Then Graham tries to spin loose and can't. And Jeff Brown clears to center ice. 4:45 left. First period, the Blues on top 3-1. They struck early. Here are the Hawks at center ice. Doug Wilson in over the line, and he can't get around Paul Cavallini. He clears it out, but Troy Murray intercepts. And the Hawks move back in. A pass for Graham too far. Loose puck goes to Gilbert in the slot. Drop pass for Doug Wilson. Wrist shot. And that's knocked down right in front of Riendo. A battle for the puck near the Blues net. Up the boards, not out, kept in, and then Mike Waller intercepts. And he'll clear it the length of the ice. Back for Dave Manson. And the Blues call for icing with 4:09 to go in the first period. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Personal service. It's something you don't find when you shop at so-called superstores.
If you're tired of being misled by empty promises, misleading ads, come to Slime Brothers and let us show you what super service and everyday low prices are all about.
We know you, St. Louis. We live here. We work here. We're not some out-of-town superstore. We've been part of St. Louis for 25 years.
So when you're shopping for GE appliances, come to Slime Brothers. We'll do what it takes to make you feel super.
Try us. You'll like us.
Face off near Riendo, and getting the puck and clearing it into the Chicago end is Brindamore. McGill goes back for it. He's on defense with Conroy. Van Dorp and Thomas are the wings. Creighton the center for Chicago. And an errant Hawk pass goes the length of the ice. And Featherstone touches it. And it is icing against the Blues, who are going to change their defense, if not their forward line. Ryan Sutter has to be pleased, John. The scoring in this period, 3 goals for the Blues, 1 for Chicago, coming in the first 5 minutes and 54 seconds. And as you mentioned, that's exactly what Brian Sutter wanted to happen. Move the puck out of our end, force them in their end, and score early.
And the Blues have done everything the coach wanted. Brian, his usual disposition behind the bench, he's very uptight before a hockey game, but when you get a couple of goals, you tend to relax. And boy, Ken, you can just hear the fans in behind our broadcast booth yelling and screaming at the Hawk goaltenders. They are not pleased with the Hawk goaltenders, and I don't blame them with their performance tonight.
Well, they've had problems the last few years with goaltending. They've really had problems since Tony Esposito retired. Hawks move in, lose the puck. Oates back up the left wing. Shoots it into the corner. After it, McLean. And he's beaten to it by Conroy. Up to Hudson. He forces it out to center ice. And here is Adam Creighton, the former Sabre. In over the line, but the rookie back, Brindamore, to slow him up. Loose puck in the corner. Brown gets it up the boards, not out. Kept in by Conroy. Then Thomas bumped by Gordy Roberts. Creighton there also, and the puck ends up on Brown's stick behind the net. No question, the Hawks are looking for goaltending as the Blues shoot at the length of the ice. Conroy back to touch it. Icing is the call. Then Oates mixing it up with McGill a bit. And the linesmen separate the pair. Bob Pulford, the general manager of the Hawks, admitting that he's in the market for a goalie. Oates and McGill still very hot. But they're at a long distance. And the word, of course, still is that the Hawks are interested in Greg Millen and also interested in the Flyers' Ken Reagan. Now Kelly Chase is on the ice, and there'll be some penalties now. Of course, that's Chase's role, John, no question. They don't want Oates to get in a battle with a fellow like Bob McGill. Let Chase go out and at least do the talking, if nothing else.
Well, you can't let your good players get bumped around, and Kelly Chase certainly won't let that happen. He, of course, has missed the last six games with a back injury, back spasms. But Kelly fit to play tonight, and he gets an unsportsmanlike conduct minor here at 16:54. McGill gets the same. By the way, Dave Lowry, who is out of the lineup tonight, his groin injury, not too severe, Ken. Lowry wanted to play tonight, but Brian Sutter decided to hold him out, so he could be ready for the next game on the weekend. But it's not a serious groin injury, but it's one of those things where you don't want to take a chance in a regular season game.
Offsetting penalties, two-minute unsportsmanlike conduct penalties to both Chase and McGill. Here at 16:54, both teams remain at full strength. The faceoff near the Blues goal. Eagles against Zezel. Blues up 3-1. Paul Cavallini has a pair of goals for the Blues. Paul McLean has the other. Troy Murray has scored the Chicago goal. That goal tied it at one. Blues clear it out of their own end. There's a penalty coming up. Now a fight. Lawler and Dwayne Sutter. Sutter's a little tougher. Lawler's a little younger. They're both about the same size, and they're feeling each other out. Clutching, grabbing. Lawler gets Sutter's jersey, gets a right in. Oh, then Dwayne Sutter connects. As Sutter loses his helmet, Sutter connects again with a right. There's a third right, and Lawler wisely pushes Sutter down, and they like it here in Chicago. Dwayne Sutter and Mike Lawler. It is trite, I agree, to say it's a playoff atmosphere, but that best describes the way things are here tonight.
Well, Brian's younger brother, Dwayne, the captain of the Hawks, I have a feeling he did that to shake up his team, and Brian knows it more than anyone because he did it so often when he was captain of the St. Louis Blues. But I'm sure the Blues will hold their own in a contest against the Hawks. Dirk, of course, gave Hudson a pretty good pounding earlier. But Mike Keenan always likes the physical play. His teams always play a very physical game. Let's take a look at how that last scrap started. It happened in the corner as Lawler hooked Sutter, and Sutter turned around. And Sutter gets a cross-checking minor, so the Blues will get a power play. Their third of the game. Blues lead 3-1. And Ken, it'd be nice to score on a power play here and take a three-goal lead into the locker room. So far, the Hawk penalty killing, like it's performed the last couple of weeks, has been very good against the Blues tonight.
Blues are 0-for-2 on the power play in Chicago in the last 47 shorthanded situations over 10 games, has allowed just four goals against. Mike Keenan has spread the responsibility around for the Blackhawks penalty killing. He gives a lot of credit to that, not wearing anyone out. Also, the Hawks have changed their penalty killing style a little bit, not conceding the red line and forcing the opposition's power play a little more. Troy Murray moves in, and the Blues take over. There's 2:45 to go in the first period, and the Blues lead the Blackhawks 3-1. So fighting penalties to Sutter and Lawler, and an extra 2 minutes for cross-checking to the Blackhawk veteran. Zezel moves it over the line, can't get around Troy Murray. A feed ahead for Graham, too far. And Riendo plays the puck into the corner for Oates, who's on the power play with Brown, Hall, Zezel, and Brindamore, who gets a pass, right wing to Brown, he'll wind her up, shoots, he scores! It deflected, and Brown makes it 4-1, and maybe the Hawks' penalty killing is not all that invincible. And the Blues have gotten, not to take anything away from them, some easy goals here in the first period. The Hawks' goaltending has not been good.
Well, that shot by Brown was like a changeup as he worked in on right wing. The Hawk defenseman, Yanni, came over and he tipped it just at the last second, and that threw Kluche off. And it went right through his legs, but the shot was tipped right when he let it go, and it was a changeup. It looked bad. It probably was a shot that could have been stopped. But Brown gets his 13th of the season, his 7th as a member of the Blues, and it's 4-1 as the Blues strike on the power play at 17:40. But a big goal there. It's now a 3-goal lead again. Of course, we've seen it the other way around, where pucks have gone in off every Blues defenseman. That happened in that game recently at the arena. And a little lady luck never hurts. Doug Wilson from center ice, a shot kicked out by Riendo. The Blues get it out of their end, clear at the length of the ice, and there's no icing. It doesn't go over the end red line. 2:05 to go, first period. Both teams at full strength. Dave Manson up to center ice, clears it in. Thomas, checked by Gino Cavallini, and Gordy Roberts has it. He sends the puck right wide to Brown, out to center ice, Wilson. This pass to Gino Cavallini, he'll have to circle back. He'll fire it in from shy of the red line, but they say no icing. And Doug Wilson in the corner, up to Wayne Van Dorn. Now to Adam Creighton, the big center. Long stick, long reach, into the corner, centers. And Thomas unable to get there. Yanni pinches in, but the puck comes to center ice with a minute and a half left in this first period, which has been a great one for the Blues. They lead the Blackhawks 4-1. Hawks shoot the puck in. Thomas digs it out of the corner. Then he's tied up by Roberts, and Ron Wilson gets the puck. Still deep in the Blues' end. Left behind the net. Here's Van Dorp looking to center. Can't get around Wilson. Paul Cavallini up the boards, not out. Van Dorp behind the net, loses the puck. Paul Cavallini can't clear. Conroy has shot going wide. And Riendo gloves the puck and holds it to stop play with 57 seconds to go in the period. That Blues goal at 17:40. Brown, a power play goal from Brindamore and Oates.
And a great pass by Brindamore coming out of his zone. The Hawks were a bit too aggressive killing the penalty kill. We talked about that, and it really was a 2-on-1, and Brown worked in on right wing and scored. Now, the Blackhawks in their last game lost in Washington 4-0. That was on Tuesday, and Mike Keenan said it was one of their worst efforts of the year. He was so mad, in fact. The Hawks got back in town yesterday. Instead of giving the club a day off, they practiced yesterday afternoon at 5 o'clock. And that is very unusual, but so far that has not worked very well tonight for the Hawks.
From the draw, Conroy a shot, and it goes off tunnel stick and high and into the crowd. I guess as unusual as that 5 o'clock practice was yesterday for the Blackhawks was the fact that after the practice, Mike Keenan, who many say will eventually be the general manager here, ended up in Bob Pulford's office for a long time, and they were talking about the fact the club had played so poorly in Washington, lost 3 of its last 4, and you can bet they were talking a lot about their goaltending and what kind of deal they might make to get a goaltender. Hawks control from the faceoff, a tricky shot. Knocked down at the defense in front of Riendo, and the puck cleared out. 40 seconds left in the opening period. Hawks shoot it back in, and the Blues clear it to center ice. It's offside. Featherstone's pass from his own territory out over the red line to Mahar.
Mike Keenan can be very tough on young players. One of those players who he's been tough on this year, Trent Yanni, getting ready for a faceoff. As is Steve Tuttle. He's out there with Rick Mahar and Sergio Mameso. A lot of Blues fans here tonight. Maureen Shanahan is here. Of course, she is the daughter of Blues chairman Michael Shanahan, and she's cheering for the Blues, but not too loudly, according to her dad. They can get pretty ornery here if they know that you are not cheering for the Blackhawks. Also here tonight, Greg and Lisa Tigas from St. Louis, celebrating Greg's 30th birthday, and they want to say hi to their kids, Sarah and Drew, back in St. Louis.
There's no question the Blues fans here are enjoying this one, as we hope you are. Blues lead it 4-1. 25 seconds remaining, first period. Momesso gets the puck and chops it in. Cloutier leaves it behind the net for Conroy, up to Van Dorp. Now it's center ice to Creighton. 15 seconds to go, long shot wide. Momesso takes out Graham heavily. Then Creighton misses a check. Momesso throws his weight around a bit. Referee Bill McCreary says, let's stop things here. Then Momesso wants to get it. Van Dorp, I believe, and Creighton steps in. And everybody has been on edge throughout this first period. Creighton and Momesso really having words, and they are two big, tough customers. Also, Van Dorp, of course, he is known for that style of play.
You got to like Momesso. He's not only scored goals, played well all year, he has been a very physical player and without any question one of the main enforcers on this team, which just proves that, you know, you don't have to just be a goon or just be a great player. He is a very well-rounded performer. He can do a lot of things.
Well, Sergio, a big guy, as you can see, 6'3", 200 pounds. And Ken, you hit it right on the head. If you can play tough and you can score goals, you are a hot commodity in the NHL because, as Brian Sutter said the other day, the goon is really going out of the game. You don't see many one-dimensional players like there used to be back in the mid-70s. There are still a few around, but Sutter admits that in the 90s, you need a player who can also play some hockey as well as play the tough role. And the penalties handed out here by Mill McCreary. Featherstone for the Blues gets a roughing minor. Adam Creighton gets a minor for roughing it well as well at 19:56. And the Blues lead 4-1. The Hawks have outshot the Blues 11-10 so far, but Ken, the Blues have executed a perfect game plan here in this first period. The key to the entire period, really, I guess a couple. They got on the board early, got a couple of soft goals, but the puck has been in and out of the Blues zone very quickly tonight.
Paul Cavallini has scored twice. Paul McLean and Jeff Brown also have goals. 4 seconds to go. The faceoff. Roberts controls in his own end, clears to center ice, and the siren brings an end to a fabulous period for the
Blues. And it put the Blues ahead 2-1.
Then at 5:54, the Blues, Zezel and Mongeau do some very good work, and Paul Cavallini will move in with a puck. He goes down at center ice, but has the wherewithal to get up and be part of the play. Zezel gets it to Mongeau, and all of a sudden a two-on-one is created, and Michel Mongeau lets go a great pass, and Paul Cavallini, losing his balance, fires home his second of the night, his seventh, to tie it, then the power play goal.
And this one was scored on Kluche. Again, it was tipped at the last second by Ioni, and it was sort of like a changeup. A big goal by Brown, the power play goal, and the Blues now lead 4-1. But the Blues had a three-goal lead here last time and lost, so, Ken, it's not over yet.
No, a long way to go, Rich, no question about it.
Indeed, fellas, great job as always. And tell those cameramen up there, the shot on Paul McLean was just outstanding.
Good pass now for Gilbert into the Blues zone. That's knocked to the corner by Jeff Brown. But it goes right to Larmer, right point McGill, a shot blocked by Paul Cavallini, and cleared to center ice. And Bob Murray back at his own line. A Hawk veteran defenseman, Murray to center ice for Roenick. He comes in on right wing, a shot! And that missed by a foot on the far side. Now Brown for the Blues. Clears it over the glass on the far side, and we'll get a faceoff to the right of Vincent Riendo.
In that first period, the Blues striking early. Paul Cavallini at 108. Troy Murray tied it on a rebound from his own shot. Then Paul McLean on the tip in at 2:45 to make it 2-1. And then Paul Cavallini again from Mongeau and Zezel. And the power play goal by Jeff Brown at 17:40. And I think it's very important that the Blues were able to pick up that power play goal because everyone talking tonight about the fact that the Hawks have been so stingy in the last 9 games, allowing only 4 power play goals to the opposition and 45 chances. So I think that was very important.
Blues lead by a score of 4-1. Off the draw in their zone, Momesso tips it ahead to Ron Wilson. Wilson from Momesso back to Wilson. He gets it near the line. Backhanded back to center ice by Lemieux. Now Paul Cavallini at his own line. Two center long slot shot off the glass. Wilson in after it on left wing. He gets it free. Now Brett Hull gets the puck in the slot. He was knocked flying by Lemieux with a big open ice hit. And the Blues control again. Here is Brett Hull. After that top hit on him, he'll dump it in. Conroy back in the far corner. He's bumped by Momesso, a big hit. And a very large collision. Now Momesso drops his gloves with Van Dorp, and here we go. Van Dorp gets the right loose. Now Momesso comes back, and he's doing a good job against the Blackhawks resident tough guy, Lean Van Dorp. And now the two fighters get it very close. Momesso a right hand. Now he falls a bit, but a rather
even match between Mimesso and Van Dorn.
And John, in that first period, after the Blues got the commanding lead, I thought the Hawks were taking the body much more, as they did in that recent game at the arena. Here, in the first 2 minutes and 10 seconds, the Hawks are trying to hit everything that they possibly can, and they're beginning to take advantage, being so physical. The Blues looking in the second period here a little gun-shy, and somebody had to go out there and stand up. And again, it was Mimesso. He went out there and threw a great check, and that caused the Blackhawks to get a little upset, but you've got to do that. 4-1, Blues lead it. This is St. Louis Blues hockey. Fighting, but you can't get knocked around all night long. And look at this. Mimesso says to Conrad, you're going to come up the wing, you're going to get hit. And of course, Van Dorp takes exception. But that was, I think, a very important move by Mimesso.
Fighting majors to Van Dorp and Mimesso at 2:10. Blues lead 4-1. Now the play in the blue zone. Five players jam up on the near side. Dirk Graham kicks it in behind the goal for Lemieux. He's roughed up by Featherstone. Lemieux knocked down, and Oates clears it around the boards. And again, the Blues get it out of their own end. And Bob McGill back in front of his own goal. Pass off the boards, knocked down at center by Oates. He kicks it back in the zone. Now picked up by Bob Murray. At center ice for Creighton. He'll flip it down the ice. As the Hawks make changes, Lawler skates in behind the Blues goal. Quick left wing pass to Oates at center ice. Oates tied up from behind by McGill. Now Roenick comes in on right wing. Drop pass in the slot. Brindamore knocked it away. Now Roenick gets it again on left wing. Shoots. Oh, save by Riendo. And he holds on as Roenick let go an ankle-high drive from well out. A good save there by Riendo.
There'll be a penalty on the play. Doug Wilson at the point with a puck. There was a lot of traffic as the play was developing. And of course, you need a lot of concentration, and Riendo did a very good job. Featherstone will pick up the 2-minute holding penalty. Featherstone knocking the Blackhawk player down, who was trying to screen Riendo. And the Blackhawks will move on to the power play here, trailing the Blues 4-1. The Blackhawks surprisingly getting their first power play of this game right here.
Well, Ken, you knew things would even up after a while. The Blues had three straight power plays. The Blues penalty killing very good this year, seventh in the NHL. The Hawks power play, fourth best in the league. Here's Doug Wilson, a drive save. Riendo on the rebound. Stop Troy Murray, and back comes Tuttle. He's on a semi-break, moves it in right wing. Tuttle in goal, and a save by the Blackhawk goaltender, Kluche. And a penalty called, I believe, on Troy Murray. As Tuttle in a partial breakaway and a slashing call.
Well, this will be interesting to get a look at. This crowd very unhappy with referee Bill McCreary tonight. Bob Murray comes back. Well, there's the slash. There's no question. Why, he hammered him on the right side, maybe the right arm. Right there. That's the slash over the back and over the shoulder. It's tough to see when you're looking at it the first time, but the veteran Bob Murray goes off for slashing at 3:23, and it takes the power play away from Chicago, and both teams will be a man short for the next minute and 43 seconds. Both coaches, Mike Keenan and Brian Sutter, become very quickly aware that it's a different game now, more open ice, and it changes the game even on this small rink. As I'm sure most of you are aware, this ice surface is much smaller than most of the other ice surfaces in the NHL. This surface and the Boston Garden ice surface are much shorter. So it's a different game, but there's still a lot of ice when you have each team a man short.
Well, Paul Cavallini, a drive off the faceoff. That's stopped by Kluche, and then in the far corner, Kelly Chase is knocked down, or rather Tuttle. Back come the Hawks. Roenick to center. He comes in on left wing. For Larmer on the left wing side. Larmer back near the line. Spins away. Gets in front, but Ron Wilson knocked it into the far corner. That last penalty, Bob Murray for slashing at 3:23. Hawks keep it in front. Larmer shoots. He scores! Larmer at 3:42.
Really?
Riendo had no chance. Number 26 for Larmer. Paul Cavallini loses the puck. Larmer still in front of the net. Roenick sets him up, and you can kiss that one goodbye. There aren't many players any better in the league than Larmer for having a sense for the net. Roenick to Larmer. Upstairs, bye-bye. And both teams remain shorthanded. Now you have that big fear that a play like that can turn the entire game around. And this crowd gets back into it.
Larmer gets number 26. The Blues clear it down the ice. And icy call here on St. Louis. Roenick gets the only assist. And that will get Mike Keenan's Blackhawks back into the game. Well, if you're going to give up the puck on a 2-on-0, don't give it to Larmer and Roenick. The Hawks, two most proficient offensive players, and that goal cannot sit too well with Brian Sutter and the Blues. That's a tough one to give up.
That's one thing about Chicago throughout the decade of the 80s. Savard and Larmer doing so much of the penalty killing, but they can be so explosive offensively. So many teams have non-scorers on the penalty killing unit, but typically not the Blackhawks.
Each team still a man short. The Blues lead 4-2 now. Oates to center ice. Into the Hawks zone. Drop pass to Brett Hull. Banned on the shot. It fluttered to Kluche. And now he clears it to Troy Murray. Up for Dirk Graham. His long drive. Riendo knocked that down. And then he nearly lost it, but gets it back for Jeff Brown. He gets it to Oates. Now to Lawler in the near corner. Return feed to Oates. In 30 seconds, the Blues will get a brief power play when Featherstone comes back on. Team still a man short, now at center ice. The pass goes behind Jeff Brown down the ice. And Dave Manson for the Hawks in his own zone. Wheels to center ice. Manson checked by Robertson. Back comes Oates. Here he comes with Brett Hull. 2-on-1, a pass to Hull. He's in the clear and a goal, a shot. Kluche! Highway robbery on Brett Hull. And play call. And Hull hooked down, but nothing called on the play.
Well, Brett Hull is the meal ticket, and every Blues player on the ice, Roberts, Oates, and Paul Cavallini, are screaming, hey, our guy got worked over. Oates, nice little flip pass to Hull. Now coming back on the play, the man with the longest reach in the world, Adam Creighton. And as the puck went to goalie Jacques Cloutier, there was no infraction by Creighton. You can see, in fact, I believe that Brett with his right hand grabbed onto Creighton's stick. And of course, Hull is unhappy, saying to referee Bill McCurry, I don't know, come on. There's no penalty there. It's worth looking at because of great camera work, getting a look at it. I think that I saw Hull grabbing onto Creighton's stick. Again, that's a situation where it's almost an automatic penalty. But on the other hand, Bill McCreary has been all ears and getting a lot of abuse from this crowd. And if it's an even-up situation in the penalty department, he definitely owes the Blackhawks. A rather interesting play there.
Well, my question is, would Hull have fallen down on a breakaway on his own? I don't think so. Anyhow, play goes on. The Blues now in a brief power play for 10 seconds. The Blues lead the game 4-2. And Roberts back in his own zone for St. Louis. Stick handles, a pass to center, goes to Manson at his own line. And now Bob Murray is back on the ice. So the team's at full strength. Roberts at center ice to Mongeau. The young rookie Mongeau has chipped him with two assists tonight. Now McLean in the far corner for Zezel behind the Hawk goal. Centers one to McLean right in front of shot. Kluche grabs that, and then McLean slashed by Manson, and he'll get a penalty. And McCreary saw that one. The Blues lead by two, and they'll get a power play. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
I said, put on some steaks and get the queen a Bud Light.
Oh. Bud Light's clean, fresh taste won't fill you up, never lets you down.
Henry, they're pop tops.
Everything else is just a light.
Dave Manson of the Hawks, who's facing his third NHL suspension for biting Scott Stevens' hand Tuesday night, will get a slashing penalty. He gets up, play is stopped, and he slashes Paul McLean. Bill McCreary, the referee, sees it. You're gone for two. But there was no penalty moments earlier as Hall broke in alone on Cloutier. What happens here? Hall, forced down by the stick, grabs on to the stick of Creighton. I think that's a call that could have gone either way.
Here are the Blues with a power play. Brown a shot, tipped high, and it goes over the glass in the far corner. Other Blues fans here tonight, Jay Ohlendorf and Leanne Fay, want to say hi to the folks in St. Peter's, Missouri. And Jennifer Ireland is here tonight from St. Charles. She wants to wish a happy birthday to Dr. Steve Hall, who's back in St. Louis. Also here tonight, Susan Gloss and Jennifer Gardner. Lots of Blues fans, and Blues lead this game 4-2, still a minute 49 to go in their power play.
So the Blues came into the period with a three-goal lead. They'd love to get another power play goal here, but again, keep in mind how stingy Chicago has been with their penalty killing lately.
Blues get the draw quickly. Zezel in front for Oates, and the puck rolls off his stick right to Cloutier, and play is called. The Blues have Brindamore up front with Zezel and Hull. Oates and Brown are the point men.
Zezel, right from that faceoff, got hammered across the face, and he goes over and says to Bill McCreary, would you pay attention? Zezel, I mean, got hammered across the forehead with a stick from a Blackhawk player. Went down as the play was going on, then got up. That's the old story. Nowadays, you get hit in the face with somebody's stick, you've got a valid complaint, because everybody's supposed to be responsible for keeping their stick down.
Blues get the draw back for Oates. Right point to Brett Hull, right in front. A shot! And it hit Yanni and went high about 15 rows back. Well, Brett Hull scored a couple of power play goals in Montreal from that spot. His 20th and 21st power play goals, and he nearly scored there.
Zezel did a very good job of the faceoff, kicking the puck back. Oates, eyes to the net, passes over to Hull. And if he would have been upstairs and not had that deflected, he would have had goal number 63. I talked with Uncle Dennis Hull before the game, who had a brilliant NHL career also, but of course, he was overshadowed by brother Bobby. And I'll tell you, Brett's uncle Dennis is thrilled as his dad Bobby is with his great season.
Now off the draw, the Hawks work it around the boards, and Graham clears it down the ice. 13:45 left in the second period. The Blues lead 4-2, and they're on a power play now. Zezel back to center ice for St. Louis. He clips it in on right wing for Rod Brindamore. He gets free behind the goal. Now Brindamore works it back on the right point. 2-0. He fanned on it, and Graham hooked down. And there will be a call here against Oates. And that's a penalty that Oates had to take as the puck bounced over his stick. The Blues lead 4-2. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Your first house, the biggest investment you've ever made. How will you protect it? Call Allstate before you close for answers and comforting prices. Another reason.
You're in good hands with Allstate.
There's another way for new homeowners to save money. The Allstate New House Discount. It could save you up to 15% on Allstate Homeowners Insurance. Another reason.
You're in good hands with Allstate.
A member of the Sears Financial Network.
Dave Manson with a minute 8 to go in his penalty as Adam Oates takes a 2-minute hooking penalty here at 6:32. Again, both teams will be shorthanded. Earlier in the period with both teams shorthanded, Steve Larmer scored to bring the Hawks back to within a pair.
From the draw, Tuttle gets it at center ice. Long dump in. Cloutier makes the save. He's in relief of Chivry, who allowed 3 goals on 6 shots back in the first period. Now at center ice, the Blues' Roberts gets it to Ron Wilson. He's tied up by Jocelyn Lemieux. Now Lemieux plays it back in his own zone. Tuttle forechecking on Yanni. Lemieux carries him behind the Hawk goal. Pass for Conroy. Center ice to Creighton. 2-on-2. Hits the Blues line. Drop pass. But Larmer was going the wrong way. Now Conroy backhands it behind the goal. For Lemieux. Roberts all over him. Adam
Creighton gets it free behind the goal. In front to Yanni, and he missed the goal mouth feed. Conroy on the right point. Gave it right to Roberts. Lead pass to Tuttle. That's center ice. Now for Ron Wilson. He'll come in on left wing. Wilson, good pass to Brown. Turns. Shoots one. Owen Kluche made a skate save there, and then he clears it up the middle. Nearly knocked down by Tuttle. It goes wide of the Blues goal. And now Manson back on. So the Blackhawks have a power play for 50 seconds. Here they come. Roenick across the line. A shot. High off the glass. Cleared but not out. Bob Murray on the right point for Doug Wilson. Into Roenick. A drive. And that was wide in the short side. Now behind the Blues goal. Roenick gets it. Ofer Larmer on right wing. He missed it. Bob Murray a shot. That's high off the glass. Now Wilson back in the left point. For Roenick. To Doug Wilson. For Roenick again, in front to Bob Murray. He works in a shot blocked by Mike Lawler. Cleared by Lawler, kept in by Doug Wilson. 15 seconds left in the Blackhawks power play. Now Troy Murray on right wing. Left point to Wilson, look out! And that was high off the glass. And Brindamore clears it by the Hawk player, but not out of the zone. Kept in. Now Mahar back for the Blues. And Oates is back on the ice. The Blues have killed it off. Again, they can't clear it away. Now it comes to Mahar. And finally, the Blues get it outside the long zone and play back in with a high stick. What action in the Blues zone. We'll pause here. 15 seconds for station identification. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Rich Gould. First with the latest scores and highlights. From the diamond to the end zone. Get the first word in sports on St. Louis's only primetime newscast, St. Louis 11 News at 9.
Well, the Blues have the lead 4-2. Brian Sutter always coaching, also with the Kleenex in his hand. He is battling a bad cold. He was really sick up in Quebec City and Montreal over the weekend and is recovering, but he's not going to let a little illness slow him down. Bill McCreary and Mike Keenan with a discussion at the Chicago bench. The Blues, of course, have won 7 of the last 10 and have just been brilliant, really, since the first of the year. The last 25 games, the Blues are 16-7-2. If you compare these teams, look at the last 15 games. Look at the ground the Blues have made up. They're 10-4-1. And the Hawks 8-7-0 over the last 15 games. And that's why the Blues are knocking on the door of first place right now.
Well, they were a dozen points behind these Hawks, but could move into a tie for first tonight. Blues lead 4-2, 11 minutes left in the second period. Teams are at full strength. Now Thomas gets it at his own line for Chicago. Up to Manson. He'll drive it down the ice. Around the boards it goes. Yanni on the left point. Works in. Plays one behind the goal. For Greg Gilbert, now in the near corner for Mike Hudson. He's held up by Mongeau. Hudson centers one off Riendo's stick, and it comes to Zizel. He's back to center. Good pass to Mongeau. One man back. Mongeau works in. Looks in front to Roberts. Zizel shoots. He scores! Peter Zizel, a big goal, and the Blues lead 5-2.
Oh, baby, is that a big goal. How about the little guy, Michel Mongeau? His third assist of the night. Zezel tips it home, but number 41, Michel Mongeau, came up after having 80 points with Peoria, the leading scorer in the International Hockey League. He holds it like a veteran. He feathers it like a veteran, and Zezel tips it home. A pretty play, and then you can see the price Zezel pays. Yanni just happens to come down with a cross check on the back of Zezel's helmet. But this is not for the faint of heart here tonight, as Zezel sends it home. And the Blues take the lead 5-2. And for Zezel, goal number 21.
Young Mongeau with 3 assists tonight. He had his first NHL goal against the Sabres. And he was called up just to fill in for Zezel over the weekend. But the way he's playing, he could be here for a while. Blues now lead 5-2. So they have that 3-goal lead again. Now the Hawks off the draw, working in. Troy Murray bumped in the corner by Lawler. Now Bob Murray pinches in from the right point. He can't get a shot in. Mimesso works it back to center ice. Mimesso out on left wing with Wilson at center and Brett Hull on right wing. Hall has not registered a point tonight, and the Blues have five goals. That's an oddity. Now Creighton back for the Hawks on right wing. Hit the St. Louis line. Hooked at by Mimesso, and Brett Hull backhands it back to center ice. Manson in his own line for Doug Wilson off his stick, and it goes right to Featherstone. Quick pass for Lawler. Center ice to Brett Hull. That went over his blade. And Dwayne Sutter for the Blackhawks shoots it right back in. Thomas in after it quickly in the far corner. Now Creighton gets it in front, but Brett Hull got back, and he knocked it away, and then he clears one off the scoreboard at center. And that draws a whistle. So Zezel gives the Blues a 5-2 lead. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
When you say taco, say 49 cents. Cause that's all it takes at Taco Bell. Hard to believe, but you know darn well it tastes so good.
Buy a 32-ounce drink and get a free Tigers or Fighting Illini basketball cup.
9:30, the time of the goal. Mongeau and Chase assist on Zezel's 21st.
That makes it 5-2 St. Louis. Now Brindamore for the Blues. Center ice to McLean, comes in with Oates. McLean cuts it in left wing. Pass to Brindamore in the corner. Behind the Blackhawk goal, Brindamore knocked down. Now he tries to get up. It comes to Adam Oates in behind the net. Oates centers one, but no one there but Roenick of the Hawks. He gave it right to Paul Cavallini. His weak shot blocked by Doug Wilson. And Larmer to center ice. In for Roenick. Drop pass to Larmer. Cuts in the slot. Larmer, look out here. A shot. And it's high over the goal. Off a leg in front. Now in the near corner. Gilbert knocked down, and Brown gets it for the Blues. Brindamore can't clear. Kept in. A shot by Conroy. Kicked up by Riendo. And again, the Blues try and work it away. Now it's chopped up in the air, and it goes over the glass. Well, the Blues are back home Saturday against the Islanders on Kazoo Night. Every fan in attendance will get a free kazoo, compliments of the Blues and Gino's Pizza. That's Kazoo Night as the Blues take on the Islanders on Saturday.
A lot of action coming up at the arena. Of course, the Islanders on Saturday the 3rd, then Chicago on the 10th. You're going to want to be there for that one. And look at this final month of the regular season. Vancouver, Detroit, Boston, Pittsburgh, Minnesota will all be at the arena. Good seats available for those games. Available at the arena box office. You can call Dialtix at 434-6600 and charge your tickets.
The Blues have been charged up tonight. They lead 5-2. 8.5 minutes left in the second period. Now Tuttle behind his goal up on left wing for Gino Cavallini. To Mahar. He backhands it down the ice. Conroy back for the Hawks. In the far corner to the left of Kluche. Now a pass to center ice. Knocked down by the Blues, and they shoot it right back in. Mike Hudson gets it for the Hawks. Hudson slashed by Gino Cavallini. Comes to center though. Now Van Dorp has to wait for Lemieux to come onside. Van Dorp a long shot. And that's gloved down by Riendo. Featherstone behind the Blues goal. Featherstone a quick pass on left wing for Roberts. To Gino Cavallini at center ice. He'll wrist it down the ice. Then he was bumped by Van Dorp. Dave Manson for the Hawks in his own zone at center ice. Off Creighton's stick. And Lawler shoots it back in. And the Hawk faithful getting on the Blackhawks right now. As Dave Manson shoots it down the ice, Thomas on right wing, a shot tip high. And that goes into the crowd. And we get another face-off. Other Blues fans here tonight, Kevin Hessler, Brett Garrow, and Gary Carr all here from St. Louis. Boy, I tell you, Mike Lawler's played much better, Ken, in the last month and a half. At one time, it was minus 14 as far as plus-minus is concerned. But Lawler now at plus 6 coming into this game.
He has played better, and the Blues coaching staff knew a month or so ago that that was going to be one of the keys, that he had to have a second half this year like he did a season ago. And he has. There's no question. The Blues, as we mentioned, in the last 25 games, 16-7-2. I mean, that's a Stanley Cup winner kind of record. And they have done it with a lot of things going right, but there's no question the defensemen have been much better than they were earlier in the season. The Blues lead the game 5-2. 7:20 to go in the second period. The puck back in the Blackhawks zone, cleared to center ice to Graham, and that was called back on a two-line offside pass.
This has been a battering kind of game. You're always paying a price in a contest like this. You're always getting slashed, getting bumped. Both teams are following through on their checks. And by that, I mean when a player passes the puck, the other fella's not going to skate by it. You are going to still get checked. There are a lot of physical things going on away from the puck. And everybody on the ice in this game is going to know when it's over that they have really been somewhere tonight.
Blues have Mongeau at center. Now he goes off, replaced by the Wilson line. Wilson, Mimesa, and Brett Hull come on the ice. Blues lead by three. Now Wilson steals into Brett Hull. He races it in right wing, a shot. Oh, he just missed the goal as Hull was right in on right wing. And the Blackhawks cleared away. Paul Cavallini back in his own zone. He has two goals tonight for Brett Hull. He turns and shoots it down the ice. Manson back in his own zone. Manson nearly lost it to Mimesa, but now works ahead on right wing. He comes to center. Lost it to Mike Lawler. He'll play it back down the ice. Bouchard of the goal. Shoots it back to center. Then Brett Hull roughed up from behind by Thomas. And that put the play offside. And Brett Hull looks to the bench and will go off here. 5-2 the Blues lead. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
People across Illinois are playing to win.
You can do it. You can do it.
Play Hoopla, the new instant game. You could win a Chicago Bulls t-shirt or up to $250 cash, even if you don't know the first thing about playing ball. Play Hoopla from the Illinois Lottery. Your shot could be right on the money.
5-2 the Blues lead. In case you've just tuned in, the Blues led 4-1 after one. And the teams have traded goals here in the second period. Now 6:25 to go in the period at center ice. Troy Murray for Chicago. He comes in on left wing. Troy Murray shot blocked by Brown. Murray gets it again in the far corner. Now to Thomas. He can't stick handle in front. Boy, the Blues defense has been very good in their own zone tonight. Now Brett Hull to center. In across the line. Into Mimesa right in. Quick shot blocked by Couche. Now Ron Wilson in the far corner. Here's Wilson. In front to Mimesa. He missed it. Now back for Gordy Roberts. Let's it go. On goal rebound. Mimesa was shot and Couche has a rebound. They score, but hold on. Will it count? The red light has come on. And no signal from McCreary. I don't think it'll count, though, but McCreary. Now Ron Wilson pushing behind the goal. Well, the Blues scored, Ken, but McCreary not helping the announcers here and letting us know if it will count.
McCreary, I believe, whistled it dead when Cloutier had his trapper on the puck in the crease. And Mimesa wisely continued on. The play coming back to Gordy Roberts. He let her rip. I mean, he lets a blast go. Cloutier comes out and makes the save. Then a rebound by Mimesa hits Cloutier in the chest. He grabs the puck. The whistle blows right there. And the question is, did Cloutier have the puck long enough? And that's one of those questions. If it was Vincent Riendo, you'd say he had it long enough. If it's Cloutier, you say he didn't have it.
Well, now a shot by Paul Cavallini is deflected. It comes outside the line, brought back in offside. And now Lawler has words with Trent Yanni. Oates is in there as well. By the way, Blues assistant coach Joe Micheletti wanted me to pass along hello to his son and daughter back in St. Louis, Allison and Adam Micheletti, not feeling the best in the last couple of days. And Joe was concerned, and he wants to say hi to Allison and Adam back in St. Louis.
5-2, Blues lead, down to 5:48 to go here in the second period. The Blues have two goals tonight from Paul Cavallini. Also goals from Paul McLean, Jeff Brown, and Peter Zezel.
Now the Blues dump it in. Bob Murray in behind his own goal. Murray, three games shy of 1,000 games as a Chicago Blackhawk, and only three other Hawks have played in 1,000 games here in Chicago.
Now the Hawks come in. Here's Mike Hudson in the far corner. He gets turned around. Now in front of backhander. Blocked, and the Blues come back. Here's Oates and McLean, two on one. Oates across the line to McLean, right in. And he lost it at the last second. And the puck shot to center ice. Now Lawler at his own line. Up to Oates. He gets it back into Blackhawk territory. And Conroy turns in front of his own goal. The former Islander Conroy to Bob Murray. Center ice to Lemieux. He plays it across the line, but Featherstone back to Brindamore. He races it in left wing. Brindamore fakes it, lets it go, and he just missed the short side. Quite a move by Brindamore there as he faked Kluche down and nearly fooled him. And the Hawks clear to center ice. Roberts at his own line. Plays it off the lines, but it comes right to the rookie Jeremy Roenick. He's checked at center by Gino Cavallini. He comes back in for Mahar on left wing, but Kluche out of the goal, poked it away. And Roenick for the Blackhawks to center ice. Play pass to Gilbert. He's hooked at by Tunnel. And the Blues take over behind their goal. Now Featherstone back there. In the far corner to Tunnel. He's played another strong defensive game. He's so good in his own zone as Steve Tunnel. Now at center ice to Gino Cavallini and on left wing for Mahar. But that was offside. And then Kluche bumps Mahar. They were entangled before. As the Blues captain says something to Kluche. 5-2 for the Blues. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Sun's coming up over the skyline.
Chicago Stadium with 4:10 to go in the second period. A pane of the protective glass has come out in the corner near the Chicago goal, so they'll repair that. The Chicago Stadium crew will come out, ladder in hand. You know, one thing now, you begin to look at the games remaining. If the Blues, who lead 5-2, can hold on and win this, they'll move into a first-place tie with the Blackhawks at 74 points atop the Norris Division. Chicago has played one less game than the Blues. Of their last 16 games, Chicago has 11 of them against Norris Division foes, and they are 500. In the Norris Division. The Blues, who are a game under 500 against teams in their own division, have only 5 of their remaining games left in their division. If you look at what's happened so far this season, the Blues have had a much better record outside the Norris Division. So having few left in the division seemingly would help Brian Sutter's team. Chicago, as we mentioned, only a 500 team in the division. A lot of games left in the division. It seemingly would hurt them. That's not to say that's exactly what's going to happen, but it certainly is a factor. It's interesting, the Blues have the fewest number of games in the division remaining at 5. Toronto and Minnesota each have 6 divisional games to go. Jacques Demers' Red Wings have 8 games left in the division, and as we mentioned, Chicago has 11. Of course, there are other factors to consider.
Like the other team's record, the Blues, for instance, have 6 games left against teams with records over 500, 8 games against teams under 500. The Blackhawks have a tougher schedule, as they have 8 games left with teams above 500 and 7 against teams with losing records. So the Hawks have a bit tougher schedule, although they have the one more game, as Ken mentioned. Blues lead this one 5-2, and then a tripping penalty called here for hooking, as Roenick was knocked down by Brett Hull, who has a smirk on his face as he goes off. And we'll see the Blackhawks power play.
Brett Hull, of course, does not receive many penalties. That's a hook if we've ever seen one.
16, Brett Hull.
Hull now only with 22 11. Minutes in penalties. Time of the penalty, 16-11. 2 minutes for hooking. It's a new generation with the Blues, and of course I know you've heard about the Blue Note Sports Shop out in West County in the Woods Mill Plaza at Clayton and Woods Mill Road. Well, Today, the newest Blue Note Sports Shop opened at 4337 East Butler Hill Road in the Schnucks Butler Hill Plaza in South County. The Blues giving away 50 free tickets each day through the 14th at that shop, and we'll tell you more about it as time goes on.
Cole for hooking at 16-21. The Blues up 5-2 shorthanded for the third time. Hawks 0-2 in the power play. Now Troy Murray a blast. Riendo a save, rebound right in the crease area. Troy Murray gets it again. That shot blocked. Now back to Wilson. Near corner for Larmer. Larmer for Bob Murray on the right point. Other point to Doug Wilson. Now Oates has lost his stick. Here's Wilson again. A drive and Riendo a blocker save there. Now Troy Murray on left wing for the Hawks. Here's Troy Murray to Wilson. His shot on goal. They score! Bob Murray on the rebound.
Having to play without a stick. Doug Wilson's shot in and out of the trapper, and it may have been Roenick who put it in. Bob Murray was right there also, but it may well have been the rookie Jeremy Roenick for his 24th goal of the season. No matter who gets credit, it's 5-3 Blues now with 3:09 to go in this second period. What a game this is. Wow, this has been something.
Well, Roenick does get the goal. Wilson and Troy Murray get the assist. The power play goal. And that cuts the Blues lead 2-2. It's now 5-3. Off the draw, the Hawks to center. Here's Trent Yanni. In on right wing for Graham. In the slot, broken up by the Blues. And back they come, Mimesa. Up for Brett Hall. He comes in on left wing. The pass over his stick, though. Bucci around the boards. Cut off by Mimesa. In the far corner. He can't center. Now back on the right point for Paul Cavallini. In front to Mimesa. He works it into the corner. Back to Cavallini again on the right point. Now to Mimesa on right wing, a quick shot, and that was nowhere near the goal. And Dirk Graham for the Hawks. His pass at center hit Mimesa, goes to Conroyd at his own line. Now 2:22 to go in the period. Boy, the Blues would love the two-goal lead at the intermission. If the Hawks score again, look out. Now Conroyd side of his own goal for Chicago. Up to Roenick on right wing. Can't go around Gordy Robertson. Back is Brown. To Mimesa at center. He'll play it in. And Doug Wilson back for the Blackhawks. Their all-star defenseman up to Jeremy Roenick. Center ice to Gilbert. He'll fire it down the ice. Riendo now kicks the puck to the near corner. Brindamore bumped hard by Roenick as those two rookies collide. Now it's shot behind the Blues goal. Roenick there. Gets it in front. Riendo side of the goal. They score! Roenick again! It's 5-4!
I don't care what league it is, you have to knock people down near your net. You've got to knock people down. You can't let the opponents stand around like that. Earlier, Roenick tries to slam Brindamore down. Who do you think's the strongest player here? No question, Brindamore. But then the play came in front, and too many Blackhawks standing around. And all of a sudden, the Blues' lead is one goal. Roenick does it again.
His 25th of the year, second in a row. It's now a one-goal lead for the Blues. And now they drop the puck at center, but they'll do it again. Well, Ken, the last time the Blues were here, the Hawks scored four goals in about 2.5 minutes and got right back in the game, and now you have to be concerned about the momentum.
You got to give Roenick credit. He kept working at the side of the net. But I just, you know, I can't stand anybody standing around there that long. Hit him, knock him down. Now we're underway. And the Hawks to center again. Dwayne center for Lemieux across the line. Lemieux in on goal, but Brown poked it away. And Jeff Brown for the Blues to center ice. Three Hawks are back. Brown for Steve Tuttle. He lost it, and it's cleared back to center ice. And Gino Cavallini for the Blues shoots it right back in. Conroy for the Hawks on the far side. Scoops it in the air to center, knocked down by Cavallini. It comes in front, and now Paul Cavallini clears it off the boards with less than a minute to go in the period. Bob Murray back in his own zone for the Hawks. That center ice to Thomas. For Dwayne Sutter, he'll flip it in wide of the goal. And Paul Cavallini back there for Gordy Roberts. And he made a good play to clear it off. Gino Cavallini down the ice, going wide of the goal. And icing called here on the Blues with 37 seconds left in the period.
There's no question. The crowd is into it. For the Blues following Roenick's second goal at 18-19, so crucial. The crowd in an uproar, the Blackhawks everywhere. And the Blues have been very calm here since that goal to bring the Hawks back to within one.
Face off left of Riendo. Hawks get the puck. Larmer knocked it wide. Now Larmer in the near corner. Bumped by Oates. Back to Bob Murray. A shot and a pad save by Riendo. And then another penalty called here on the Blues. A tripping call, and the Hawks will have a power play and a chance to tie the game.
Gordy Roberts will go off. But Greg Gilbert went flying, maybe well by his own doing, but it's a penalty, and here come the Blackhawks on the power play, down 5-4. The period started with the Blues up 4-1. Larmer scored early in the period, then Zezel got the lead back, but Roenick, a power play goal at 16:51, and Roenick again at 18:19.
22 seconds left in the period. Now off the faceoff, Larmer knocked down by Lawler. Now they drop the puck. Hawks control, Troy Murray on right wing. On the boards. Murray checked by Lawler. Now Lawler gets it in the corner. Wilson there as well, 10 seconds left. The Blues clear it, not out. Now Wilson does clear it by the puck player Murray to center ice. This should about do it. Hawks come back in, but now it's cleared to center again, and the horn sounds to end the second period. Well, the Blues led by 3-1, but their lead has been trimmed to a single goal. The score now after 40 minutes. The Blues...
That ties the game at 3, and then Boston will take the lead and win it. Dave Poulin off the draw, and watch the shorthanded goal coming up. Here's the draw. And Poulin gets a breakaway. Good skating. He cuts between two. He will go end-to-end, avoid the collision, and score. Final score, Boston wins it 5-3. A point-shaving scandal has rocked North Carolina State. It has put Coach Jim Valvano's job in jeopardy. The school awaits an NCAA and FBI investigation. Three players allegedly involved, including Charles Shackelford and Vinny Del Negro, who said he had nothing to do with it.
Anybody that knows me knows my reputation. It's unfortunate that my name has to be brought into it, but being at the position I'm at right now in the NBA, maybe that's the reason they're pulling me into it. But I got a game to play tonight, and I'm really not worried about it.
I'm angry. I'm bitterly disappointed. I'm discouraged. But yet, I also feel helpless in terms of, I mean, I'm a spectator right now, like many people.
I'm a friend of Jimmy Valvano, and everything is Jimmy Valvano, Valvano, Valvano. What about the character development of the youngster? It starts with mama and papa. Coaches today are accountable if a kid gets involved in drugs. Coaches are accountable if a kid gets involved and he doesn't graduate. What about it starting at home and the development of a youngster as an individual?
All right, tell you about somebody who goes all out all the time. That's Anthony Bonner as the Billikens lead in overtime, 87-84. Bonner with 45, a career high, and counting. It's 87-84 in OT. Bills at Evansville Sunday at 6, and we will televise that one. And if you read the paper this morning, you know Cardinals pitcher Rick Horton is calling this lockout a war. Rick said the players are preparing for a long work stoppage.
It's been very frustrating. I think it's the best word for it, Al. We spent a very long time discussing pay for performance. We spent a very long time discussing salary caps and changes that and entire changes in the system that we were not comfortable with, didn't understand, and we felt would be bad for the game. And we discussed them ad nauseum. And now, at the drop of a hat, we're asked to consider signing something in a very short period of time that's more like what we wanted in the first place.
All right, Blues lead at 5-4. We'll take it back to Chicago. Ken and John standing by with second period highlights. And fellas, with Chicago coming back like that, I've got a bad feeling.
I'll tell you something, Rich. You can't really predict what's going to happen in this game. We're rooting for the Blues to pull it out and move into a tie for first place, but I'll tell you, if you've got a weak heart, be careful. Be sure you're sitting down for the third period. The way that second period started, John, the Blues were definitely in command, but when Paul Cavallini committed that giveaway at his own blue line, that really hurt.
Well, that's sort of what the Blackhawks back in the game, got the crowd back in the game. And on the goal, Cavallini was the last man back, and he gave the puck to Jeremy Roenick, and he came in with Larmer on a 2-on-0 break. And those are the last two guys he'd want on a 2-on-0 break. And, of course, Larmer scored to make it 4-2.
So let's take a look at that goal.
When you're the last man, you got to get the puck out of the zone, as we said. And Roenick just stripped him of the puck, and then Larmer put it top shelf over Riendo's glove. That made it 4-2 and really changed the complexion around.
Then the Blues came back at 9:30. Michel Mangeau with his third assist. The little guy gets the puck. What he does really well is he has the wherewithal to hold it, see the entire ice, flips it in front, and Zezel tips it past Cloutier for his 21st goal. Chase also picks up an assist. But then Chicago came back, and Jeremy Roenick got the first of his two on a power play.
Well, Wilson let a shot go, and a big rebound given up here by Riendo. This was the key to the goal, as he put it right back in front of Roenick's sweep. Swept in the rebound under Vinny's stick.
That was at 16:51, then at 18:19, what I call the stand-around goal. Roenick, now they have two defensemen in front with one man. That leaves Roenick at the side of the net hammering away, but they never even knock Gilbert down. Nobody gets knocked down.
On the goal, now that we look at it again, Riendo lifted his stick can and tried to clear it away, and when he did that, that's when Roenick shot it under his legs. So it was a bad goal to give up, and now you have to sort of cross your fingers and batten down the hatches for the third period. It will be tough.
Yeah, it's going to be a long way to go. There's no question about it. The crowd is into it. The Blackhawks are playing well. This really is an outstanding game, and let's just hope, Rich, that the Blues can hang on and win this one.
John said it best. He said batten down the hatches. John Kim, thank you very much. We're back with the Blues recap on St. Louis 11 after the game. We'll also have that Billikens final for you. For the Bush Sports Break, I'm Rich Gould. We'll see you then.
I've been playing professional hockey for over 13 years, and I know tough. And that's the best word to describe these good-looking, hard-working GMC trucks, tough. Your Midwest GMC truck dealer has made it easier than ever to own one of these GMC trucks. With low APR, GMAC financing, or cash back, there's never been a better time to buy than right now. Choose from dozens of models with value packages to fit your needs. An easy deal on a tough GMC truck.
Bellman GMC Truck, Florissant, Bomarito GMC Truck, Ellisville, Brockland GMC Truck, Fairmount City.
A lot of movers these days talk about price rather than service.
But do you really want the lowest bidder to move your valued possessions? Making quality service affordable has made United America's number one family mover, because there's no substitute for the extra protection of our exclusive sanitized treated vans, our guaranteed on-time deliveries, or the helpful facts we provide about your new city. At United, the only thing we have to sell is service, and the quality shows in every move we make.
You can win this fully equipped bass rig in the biggest fishing sale in St. Louis history. Grandpa's Meet the Pros Fishing Spectacular. Save 20% on all Daiwa rods, including these Team Daiwa Procaster, Samurai, and Apollo series. 275-yard Berkeley Trilene XL and XT fishing line. $349 after rebate. Plus, you can meet TV fishing stars in person at all our stores all week long. So come to Grandpa's Meet the Pros Fishing Spectacular. You're going to love fishing with your grandpas.
Well, the Blues have a precarious one-goal lead as we get set for the third period. It's 5-4 in that second period. Larmer made it 4-2 at 3:52. The Blues got their three-goal lead back again as Zevel scored at 9:30. It was 5-2. The Blues were cruising, but the two goals by Aruna got the Hawks right back in it. His power play goal at 16:51, and he scored again at 18:19 from Bob Murray and Gilbert in the period. The Blues were outshot 15-9, and the Hawks have 26 shots on Riendo. The Blues 19 on the Hawk goaltenders. Of course, Chevrier began the game, was yanked after giving up three goals and six shots, and Kluche has done a good job in relief. I was talking to Mike Keenan about that this morning. I said, well, Mike, aren't you concerned about pulling goaltenders so often? They've done it 14 times this year. He said, well, baseball pitchers don't get unnerved when they're yanked from a game after the first inning. In baseball, it happens all the time. Why not in hockey? And it's worked tonight for the Hawks. Well, the Blues are shorthanded here. Roberts, a trippy miner, still has 1:38 to serve. And here with the third period is Ken Wilson. Rick Behar killing the penalty, shoots it in. Tunnel also on with Paul Cavallini and Mike Lawler. Here come the Blackhawks to center ice. Bob Murray on the power play to Doug Wilson. He sends it into the corner. Paul Cavallini up to Tunnel, and quickly the Blues clear it out. 1:10 remaining in Roberts' penalty. Now Wilson on with Oates. Lawler and Paul Cavallini killing the penalty. Lawler, a good job at center ice checking Ronan. Hawks in their own end, trailing 5-4 on the power play. Bob Murray to the red line, blasted into the corner, moving in Graham, a shot partially blocked, flip-flops to Riendo, and he grabs it to stop play with 52 seconds to go in Gordy Roberts' penalty.
Can I mention the Blues have 19 shots on goal so far. Brett Hull has four shots in the game, three in that second period. The Hawk leader so far, Doug Wilson, has seven shots on goal. He hasn't scored. In that second period, Jeremy Roenick had five shots himself, and of course he had a couple of goals. The Blues, Adam Oates killing off this penalty, which has 52 seconds to run. Oates out there with Wilson, Lawler, and Paul Cavallini. When the Blues lead after two this year, their record 27-2-2. When the Hawks trail after two, their record 3-21.
Face off and the puck along the boards. Oates has it and sends it the length of the ice, right on goal. Bob Murray, who was exiled to the International Hockey League last season, rejuvenated this year to center ice, and he loses it. Wilson, a pass just out of the reach of Oates. Half a minute to go on the Chicago power play. They have the puck in their own end. Creighton with it. And the two Wilsons, Doug and Ron, come together. Paul Cavallini keeps it in to Ron Wilson, right on the save, and Tunnel scores! A shorthanded goal on a rebound! Steve Tunnel! And the Blues lead is 6-4. Oh, how about that? What a job by the Blues there. Shorthanded to get their sixth goal. Is that a huge goal?
Great work by Wilson in the corner. He got the puck free, and then Paul Cavallini centered 1-2 Wilson. His shot blocked, and Tunnel jammed in the rebound by Kluche. Tunnel gets it, and for the Blues, hard-working winger, his 11th goal of the year. And a huge goal there
for St. Louis. It's now 6-4.
Cody Roberts still in the penalty box for 12 seconds. Here are the Hawks. Gilbert can't move in. And Tuttle flips the puck the length of the ice. Roberts ready to come back on. Chicago, Trent Yawney on defense with Steve Conroy. Over on the wing. And Roenick takes a bump as he shoots it in. Roberts back on. Blues come out of their own zone. A feed for Tuttle too far. And the Blues will change players. Hawks come to center ice. Steve Larmer. He'll shoot it in. And back for it goes Featherstone. Off the boards for Momesso. Roenick really crunched Featherstone. Pass through center ice. Back for it Bob Murray to Dirk Graham. At his own line, the Hawks' Captain Graham drives it into the corner, bouncing puck, and Brown plays it. He's taken down by Thomas, who gets the puck behind the net. Unable to center, taken out in the corner. And the puck to Doug Wilson, back to Dirk Graham. Oh, he's shot, and Griendo gets just enough of that. In the corner, Thomas for Chicago. The Blues are up 6-4. Behind the net to Dirk Graham, he can't center. Then Thomas knocked down by Featherstone. Troy Murray upends Ron Wilson, who ends up lying on the puck. And that'll stop play here early in the third period. The Blues with a lead of 6-4. That goal, Tuttle getting it at 1:20.
Tuttle got the goal as 11th, his first shorthanded goal. Made it 6-4. Dirk Graham nearly got the Blackhawks back within one as his shot seemed to hit the outside of the goalpost. Riendo may have gotten a piece of it. On that goal, Ron Wilson and Paul Cavallini pick up assists. So Paul Cavallini with a three-point night now, two goals and one assist. Tuttle's 11th at 1:20, a shorthanded goal. And that's the second straight game the Blues have scored a shorthanded goal. Of course, they got that big shorthanded goal by Adam Oates against the Sabres. So it's 6-4 again. The team's now at full strength.
Mike Eagles loses the draw to Oates. Puck behind the Blues net. First time we've seen Eagles since the opening period. Lemieux centers. Right point. Trent Yawney moves into the corner. Now Dwayne Sutter behind the net. Into the corner. A shot by Lemieux, and that's kicked out. Here's Conroy to blast. Tip wide by Dwayne Sutter. Brindamore can't get it out. Eagles keeps it in. A shot that misses the mark. Jocelyn Lemieux bumped in the corner. Paul Cavallini can't clear the puck out. McLean takes out Lemieux. Eagles pokes the puck to Dwayne Sutter in the corner. The Hawks are dangerous. To the point, Conroy, wrist shot right on. Stick save by Riendo. Hawks keep the pressure on. Eagles behind the net. Carries into the corner. In the slot to Sutter. He's knocked down by McLean. Back to Conroy. What a great save by Riendo to rob Conroy. And the Blues move to center ice, led by Oates. Coming up to the four-minute mark of the third period, Oates can't move in. Back the other way, Jeremy Roenick. Over the line to Larmer. His shot, and that goes off Waller into the corner. The Blues are up 6-4. Featherstone clears to center ice. Doug Wilson shoots the puck back in, offside Chicago. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Couldn't do it, huh? Get a sausage and egg biscuit, biscuits and gravy, or bacon and egg biscuit for just 99 cents at Hardee's. Go for it.
That Blue shorthanded goal again. Tuttle is 11 from Wilson and Paul Cavallini at 1:20, making the score 6-4 Blues.
And the Blues have the puck. Waller to center ice, shoots it in. Behind the net, Cloutier up the boards for Larmer. Now to Roenick. Left wing to Greg Gilbert. The former Islander fakes a shot, moves into the slot, back to Bob Murray. Oh, and that screenshot goes just wide of the post. And the puck bounds all the way to the Chicago blue line. Wilson's pass for Roenick. Slowed up by Mahar, puck back deep in the Chicago zone. Bob Murray behind his net. Has trouble with a puck, gets it to Roenick. He's stopped by Mahar, trying to gain possession. A bouncing puck comes to Tuttle, and a shot over the net off the glass. Steve Larmer the Hawks' leading scorer with a goal tonight. That center ice for Thomas. He avoids a check and loses the puck. And Kelly Chase gets it. Right wing to Mongeau, has three assists into the corner. Michel Mongeau centering, and it's tipped away from Zezel. Now the Hawks on the attack. Troy Murray ahead for Thomas off his stick. The puck ends up behind the Blues net. Blues get back nicely. Up the wing it comes to Kelly Chase. At center ice for Mongeau, trying to move around Yawney and bumped down. Graham back for the puck with less than 15 minutes to go in the third period. Hawks can't clear. Mongeau to Brown, shot right on off the chest of Cloutier. Mongeau out near the blue line with a rebound. Sends the puck behind the Hawks net. Cloutier clears it up the boards. Thomas tries to move it to center ice. He's hit, but gets it out of his own zone. Then Graham with a high stick knocks the puck down, and we'll have a neutral center ice faceoff with 14:28 remaining. And the Blues leading the Blackhawks in this battle for first place, 6-4.
Youngster Michel Mongeau goes off, another good shift. Three assists tonight. Blues have six goals, lead 6-4, and Brett Hall has not scored a goal or registered an assist. Hall has another scoring streak going. Now with points in seven straight games for Brett Hall, 10 goals, 2 assists during that span. He scored 7 goals against the Blackhawks this year, but they've done a very good job in containing him, although Kenny has had a couple of chances. He was hooked down on a breakaway back in the second period and has had a few more shots, but by and large, he's been contained.
Brett Hall with 62 goals, 11 game winners, 21 power play goals on the ice. He gives the puck away in his own zone, gets it back. Then Momesso to Hall up the wing with Wilson. And Doug Wilson of the Hawks intercepts to Dwayne Sutter, and he'll shoot it in. 6-4, Blues lead it. If they win it, they move into a first-place tie with Chicago. Momesso with Wilson and Hall at center ice. Now to Wilson over the line, moving in around Bob Murray, and he can't get the last step. And Bob Murray will bring the puck to center ice. He'll flip it in. Jordy Roberts plays it to Momesso. Here are the Blues. At center ice to Hall, his long shot off Doug Wilson wide. And the Blues are changing on the move. Doug Wilson, former Norris Trophy winner, to Gilbert. Now to Roenick, looking for the hat trick. Drop pass at the blue line. They say offside. 13:36 to go. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
People across Illinois are playing to win.
You can do it. You can do it.
Play Hoopla, the new instant game. You could win a Chicago Bulls t-shirt or up to $250 cash, even if you don't know the first thing about playing ball. Play Hoopla from the Illinois Lottery. Your shot could be right on the money.
13:36 to go. Neutral faceoff. Yawney for Chicago fires the puck in. Blues are up 6-4. What a game this has been tonight here in Chicago. Ken Wilson with John Kelly and Bruce Affleck trying to hold on. Lahar tips the puck into the Chicago end. Yawney back for it. These two teams meet again twice. The 10th of March, Saturday night at the arena. Sunday the 11th here in Chicago again. And most likely in the playoffs. Blues in their own zone, hemmed in a bit. Then Roberts gets it out to Gino Cavallini. He's stopped at center ice. Play back in, and Brown clears to the neutral zone. Doug Wilson on the charge. Around Roberts, then knocked down. No penalty, the crowd unhappy. At center ice, Oates. Left wing to Gino Cavallini, his blast! And Cloutier gets just enough of it to send it wide. Picking up speed in his own end is Troy Murray. He loses it to Oates, but he can't get loose. The puck slips away. Oates, by the way, has had 2 assists tonight. And Adam Oates has 12 assists against Chicago in half a dozen games. Troy Murray, a shot from the blue line just wide of the mark. McLean clears up to Oates. Back to Featherstone in his own end. He just whacks it off the boards to center ice. A battle along the boards. 5 players there. And finally, back in the St. Louis zone, Lawler gets the puck and clears it off the boards into the Chicago end. 12:02 to go in the third period. The Blues lead by 2 goals. Pass at center ice, broken up by Featherstone, a bouncing puck. Conroy and McLean battle for it at the Chicago line, and here's Mike Eagles. The former Nordique shoots it in. It bounds to Riendo. He leaves the puck for Lawler, and as the Hawks change, McLean gets the puck. Paul McLean to center ice. He'll shoot it in, and the Blues will change themselves. Hawks back in their own territory. Thomas on the left wing. Cuts to the middle. 11 and a half to go. 6-4 Blues as Thomas backhands the puck in. Jordy Roberts back for it. The Blues are not going to hesitate clearing the puck out as Roberts does. Doug Wilson takes it in his own end. Plays it to an open side. Paul Cavallini pinches in the corner where Eagles throws his weight around. Chase's check. Monjo centers. And Zezel is beaten to the puck by Bob Murray to Creighton. 2-on-2 with Lemieux. Jocelyn Lemieux can't move around Roberts, who takes him to the board with a heavy hit. Puck behind the Blues net. Paul Cavallini has it. Nicely to Chase. At center ice for Zezel, and he's poke checked. Conroy shoots it back in for Chicago. Less than 11 minutes remaining. 6-4 Blues here at the stadium in Chicago. Standing room only as Chase is crunched. Gets it ahead out of Zezel's reach. Yanni back near his own goal for the puck. Blues are changing again to Hudson. Now finally at center ice, Van Dorp stopped. Here's Hall trying to cut in around Yanni. Hall ends up behind the net. He's tripped down. There'll be a penalty. Trent Yanni will pick up a penalty for upending Brett Hall. And the Blues, with a 6-4 lead, will have the man advantage. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
On right wing, and Yanni did everything but put handcuffs on Brett Hull. He held him, hooked him, pulled him down, and he goes off for holding at 9:37. The Blues lead 6-4, and they get their sixth power play. They're 1 of 5 tonight. By the way, Ken, I wanted to congratulate the Smet High School hockey team. They won the Mid-States Championship last night with an 8-3 victory over CBC at the arena. So another Mid-States High School Championship for the Smet hockey team. Congratulations to those folks.
There'll be a face-off near Jacques Cloutier. A two-minute penalty to Yanni. Blues lead it 6-4. Philadelphia has scored in the first period at the Olympic Saddle Dome. They lead Calgary 1-0. Boston was leading at Montreal in the third period 5-3. Here it is 6-4 Blues. Paul Cavallini has a couple of goals. The other goals from Paul McLean, Jeff Brown on a power play, Peter Zezel, and Steve Tuttle with the Blues shorthanded. Paul Cavallini in his own end. On with Brown. Brindamore, who has the puck. Oates. And a fellow named Hall who gets it. Brett Hall over the line to Oates. Now at the right point, Paul Cavallini gets it. Ahead to Brindamore, now to Oates, in front for Hall, but Graham intercepts and clears it the length of the ice. 1:20 to go in the Blues power play. They lead it 6-4. 9:40 remain in the third period. Brown up to Hall. Hall without a goal. Hall backhands the puck behind the net. Cloutier out of the crease. Plays it around the boards for Larmer. To Ronick. 2-on-1. Brown back. Back to Larmer. Brown plays it nicely. Forces the play into the corner. Back to the point. McGill. And a pad save by Riendo on a drive by Bob McGill, who has the puck in the corner. Centers to Conroy in the slot. His shot turned away by Hall. And a brilliant defensive play. Now the Blues still with 42 seconds to go and the man advantage. Hall will move in over the right wing. Looks for Momesso in front. And a pass to him fails to reach him. And McGill checked by Momesso. And the Hawks try to clear Kent. Featherstone in front. A pass to Hall. Broken up and cleared away by Bob McGill. Yanni has 23 seconds to go in his penalty. Blues 6, Blackhawks 4. Lomessa leads the way out of the blue zone to Oates. Right wing for McLean, but he's offside. Hawks clear it out. Blues trying to get possession of a bouncing puck in the center ice area. And Bob Murray comes up with it. And Yanni ready to come back on as Bob Murray sends the puck into the blue zone. So the Blues tonight, 1-for-6 in the power play. Chicago is 1-for-4. And it's McGill turning in his own end. Up to his blue line. McGill to the red line. Blasts it in. The Hawks flood the zone. In the corner, Creighton gets the puck. Carries behind the net. Into the corner, taken out. Hudson is there also, but McLean gets the puck ahead to Gino Cavallini, and he'll send it the length of the ice. They wave off icing. Wilson back to McGill. 7:45 to go. To Hudson at the red line. It's Thomas trying to split the defense. He's knocked down. And Lawler takes the puck. The crowd thought there should have been a penalty. Mike Lawler flips the puck in. The Blues now thinking about quick line changes and just getting the puck out of their own end. Defense is all they're worried about. 7:22 to go. Conroy from the red line fires it in. Troy Murray, a shot turned away. Now it's Lemieux. Here's Thomas. He can't get in front. The Hawks doing a good job. Lemieux. Back to the point. Conroy. Deflection. Thomas. He stopped. Blues puck. And the Blues clear it out. Oh, my. Was that a close call? Now the Hawks throwing everything at the Blues. Conroy shoots it in again. Zezel tries to clear it out. Bob Murray keeps the puck in. Behind the net to Graham. He centers and Roberts tips it away. Puck behind the Blues net. Zezel comes up with it. Can't clear it out. Roenick back by the blue line to Doug Wilson. Slap shot wide. Zezel can't clear it out. Here's Bob Murray to the side of the net. Behind the goal. Pulled down. Centers. Zezel intercepts and Larmer centers. Out to the right point to Roenick. To Bob Murray. And a shot wide. Now Doug Wilson at the left point. His high shot over the net. And finally the puck comes out of the blue zone. Wow, this is tough on the heart. 6-4, Blues lead it. 6 minutes to go. Third period. The Hawks are firing everything except your old Aunt Mabel at the Blues here. Blues thinking defense, but they've got a lot to try to stop. Hall almost intercepts. Creighton moves the puck ahead to Hudson. 3-on-2 to Gilbert. Penalty coming up against the Blues. Behind the net to Hudson. Blues touch the puck and play is stopped. And now the trouble really begins. The Blues are going to be shorthanded with 5:39 to go. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
When you say taco, say 49 cents. Cause that's all it takes at Taco Bell. Hard to believe, but you know darn well it tastes so good.
Buy a 32-ounce drink and get a free Tigers or Fighting Illini basketball cup.
Well, Mimesso takes a high sticking minor at 14-21. The Blues lead by 2, and they will face the Hawks power play. The high stick occurred in the Blues zone right at the edge of the goal. And now the Blackhawks, 1-of-4 on the power play, get a big chance. Boy, did they ever come close 3 or 4 or 5 times before the penalty. Wilson let a shot go, and then Thomas got the puck near the goal line. It hit the goal post, and then how Thomas did not jam it in, I don't know. It came right in front. Brando was knocked down, and Ron Wilson, who had a superb defensive shift, cleared it away. And now the Hawks in a power play. Blues have to hold on. Cleared out by Paul Cavallini. Going the penalty with Mike Lawler, Tuttle, and Mahar. Mahar steals, moving in, cutting in front, backhand shot. Oh, and somehow Cloutier keeps it out. Back the other way, Troy Murray. He'll shoot the puck in. Hawks knock it down, Roenick in the corner. Blues intercept, can't get it out. Now Mahar tries to, and Wilson keeps it in for Chicago. Behind the net to Larmer in the corner to Ronan. Right point to Bob Murray. Then Paul Cavallini intercepts up the tunnel, and it's cleared out to center ice, and Mahar sends the puck into the Chicago zone. A minute 12 to go in Momesso's penalty. The Blues have a two-goal lead. Hawks dump it in again. Under 5 minutes remaining. Creighton in the corner. Attempts to center. Blues intercept. Can't get it out. Yanni keeps it in. Behind the net to Graham. Creighton is in front. Along the boards to Thomas. Right point to Manson. Then a pass for Thomas gets away. And play stopped in front as Brown and Creighton were doing some bumping and slashing. And there'll be a penalty or more here with 4:34 to go in the third period, and the Blues up 6-4. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Basketball is my favorite sport. I like to win and dribble up and down the court. I like slam dunks and taking it to the hoop. My favorite play is the alley oop. I like to pick and roll. I like to give and go. Cause it's basketball, but Mr. Kirch's flow.
Bills battle Evansville in the regular season finale Sunday at 6 on St. Louis 11.
Creighton and Brown get high sticking minors at 15-26. The Blues still shorthanded, up 6-4. 48 seconds to go in the Blackhawks power play. 4:25 to go in the third period. Graham at center ice for Chicago. Roenick goes to the net. They can't get it in front, and Mike Lawler intercepts and clears the puck the length of the ice. It's the final month of the regular season, and the Blues are just over 4 minutes away from moving into a first-place tie. Centered by Wilson of the Blues, Couturier knocks it down, clears it ahead to Roenick. Roenick carrying the puck in, checked by Roberts. Then a Ron Wilson pass eludes Lawler, but Roberts takes over behind the net, finds an opening, and clears the puck the length of the ice. Both teams are changing. Momesso back in 5 seconds. Chicago running out of time. To center ice, it's Conroy shooting it in. 3:40 to go. 6-4 Blues. Now back on Momesso. Puck behind the Blues net. Paul Cavallini holds it long enough for a faceoff. Play is stopped. Let's pause 15 seconds for station identification. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
There's one secret ingredient that goes into every Emo's pizza, sandwich, and salad. Tradition. Over 25 years of nothing but fresh, natural, quality ingredients. Check the yellow pages for the Emo's nearest you.
Hunter, weeknights at 11 on St. Louis 11.
Well, Ken, you mentioned earlier the newest Blue Note Sports Shop opened today at 4337 East Butler Hill Road at the Schnucks Butler Hill Plaza in South County. We want to remind folks that Rod Brindamore will be at the store tomorrow from 6 to 7 p.m. And then Sunday, Curtis Joseph and Vince Rienda will be at the South County store from 1 till 2. The address of that store, 4337 East Butler Hill Road in South County.
Hawks win the faceoff in the Blues zone. Yanni moves it along the boards, ends up behind the net. Hit hard by Featherstone. Conroy pinches up. Battle for the puck in the corner. It comes behind the net. Jocelyn Lemieux falls down. Paul Cavallini on the ice. Mike Hudson trying to center. Can't. Now behind the net. Jocelyn Lemieux to Hudson. He's bumped. Puck still behind the Blues net. Finally centered. But by Gilbert all the way back into the Chicago zone. 3 minutes remaining. Hawks a pass too far for Gilbert. The length of the ice, and it's an icing call against the Blackhawks. 6-4, Blues lead it. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Sun's coming up over the skyline. Coming up with all the news, just right for me. So right.
From Boston, the Bruins beat Montreal 5-3. The first place Bruins now 83 points, 6 points ahead of third place Montreal.
The faceoff in the Chicago end. Larmer has the puck to Doug Wilson. Here they come. Hawks need two to tie it.
Wilson fires it in. Zuzel back. Near his net. Tries to get it out. Can't. Roenick keeps it in. Right point. Bob Murray. Screenshot. It's deflected wide. Ends up on the back of the net. Kick loose. Zuzel can't clear. Bob Murray behind the net. And the pass intercepted by Lawler and cleared out. Puck will go back into the Chicago zone. Over the end red line. Touched by Gilbert. And it is an icing call against the Blues. The faceoff will be back near Vincent Riendo with 2:19 to go in this third period, and the Blues up by 2 goals. Our broadcast tonight, authorized under broadcasting rights granted by the St. Louis Blues Hockey Club Incorporated, solely for the entertainment of our viewing and listening audience. Any publication, rebroadcast, or other use of the description and accounts of this game without the express written consent of the St. Louis Blues Hockey Club Incorporated is prohibited.
Can't remember the last game against the Hawks in St. Louis. The Hawks won 8-3. They got a couple of lucky goals, but by and large, they deserved to win. You can really say the same thing tonight. The Blues got a couple of soft goals on Chevrier, built their lead, but there's no question they've outplayed the Hawks, and they deserve a 6-4 lead at this time.
A false start in the faceoff near Riendo, and there's 2:18 to go. Of course, the Blues are home, John, on Saturday night against the New York Islanders, and they're a struggling team now.
Well, they are. They had that great middle portion of the season, a bad start, but they have fallen on hard times. That will be Kazoo Night Saturday against the Islanders, sponsored by Gino's Pizza. All fans will get a kazoo.
Could be noisy.
Should be noisy.
I hope so.
First place club, it better be noisy.
Hope there'll be a big crowd. Why don't you come on out Saturday night? Blues shoot the puck into the Hawks zone, breaking out Troy Murray with Thomas over the line. Blues are back to protect Riendo. Around the boards to Graham. Behind the net for Thomas. Mahar intercepts. Up to Wilson. Not out. Yanni keeps it in. Troy Murray behind the Blues net trying to center. Can't. Steve Thomas in the corner. Attempts to move in front. Mahar stops him. Ron Wilson can't clear it out. Yanni a drive. Right on Riendo. Can't hold on. And the rebound gathered in by Brett Hull. And he just clears it back to the Chicago defense. There's a minute and a half remaining. The Blues have a 6-4 lead. They'll be in first place, tied with Chicago if they can hold on. Both teams are changing. Larmer near his own net. Long pass at center ice, too far. It goes the length of the ice. Brown dashes back, touches it. Icing is the call against Chicago with 1:16 to go. Well, the Blues eyeing some revenge for that 8-3 loss to the Blackhawks. And look now like they are going to pick up a victory. And both teams will have 74 points after this game. And you can't help but look ahead to the 10th and 11th when they play back-to-back games home and home. And that's the way it will be in a minute and 16 seconds. It's never over until the siren is sounded, but it looks awfully good. Brian Sutter very happy today, saying, "I'm just thrilled on the 1st of March to be playing for first place." So now he should be able to say, "I'm thrilled to death to be in first place." And you know darn well he's going to say next, "But we've still got a long way to go."
Well, they do. The Hawks have a tough weekend, Ken. They have the Boston Bruins in Boston on Saturday and home Sunday. So they play the best team in the NHL back-to-back this weekend. And, of course, next weekend, as you mentioned, these two teams meet for a home-and-home series.
It would be nice to see the Hawks go into a continuing skid. If they lose this one, the Blackhawks will have lost 4 of 5. Puck in the Hawks zone, now less than a minute to go. Yanni starts out. Puck stolen by Hull. Then Hull pulls up centers, but it's out of the reach of Gino Cavallini. 50 seconds to go. Hawks can't even get out of their own end. Now they clear to center ice. Brown shoots it right back. The Blues have been superb here in this third period. They lead it 6-4. Conroy carries to center ice, shoots the puck in. Then Jocelyn Lemieux after it behind the net. Check taken out and the puck pinned against the boards. And play halted with 31 seconds to go. You look back at this period, John. That shorthanded goal that Steve Tuttle scored at 1:20 really took the pressure off and really allowed the Blues to play an entirely different period than they would have had to play had the score remained 5-4.
I agree. That was obviously a big goal, and Riendo has done a nice job in nets tonight, especially here in the third period. But the Blackhawks have had only 5 shots on goal in this third period. The Blues have had 5 themselves, but anytime you can hold a club to 5 shots,
in the third period on their home ice, you are doing a very good job. Well, the Hawks will call a timeout here and pull their goaltender as Coach Mike Keenan wants to talk to his club. Actually, Brian Sutter called that last timeout. Blues home on Saturday against the Islanders. Then they hit the road for a couple in New Jersey and in Detroit. And the Blues back home a week from Saturday against Chicago. That's March 10th. A rather busy month of March for the St. Louis Blues. They have the Hawks in the 10th. The Canucks are in on the 15th. Detroit on the 17th. And then the Blues wind up the season with three straight home games. The 27th against Boston, Pittsburgh on the 29th, and the North Stars in the season finale on the 31st. Call 434-6600 for tickets, and there are seats available for all the Blues regular season games. And Ken, you can also pick up your Stanley Cup playoff packages through the Blues sales department. The first two rounds of the Norris Division playoffs are now on sale. Call 781-BLUE.
There's plenty of reason to be optimistic, that's for sure. Face off in the Blues zone. Hawks Creighton finally gets the puck in the corner, plays it around behind the net to Larmer on the far side. 21 seconds left. To the point to Roenick, his pass broken up by Mahar. A feed ahead for Wilson at center ice. He's knocked down by Troy Murray. Over the line, Thomas's shot blocked. And the puck into the corner, 8 seconds to go. Steve Tuttle gets it out. The Hawks net empty, the puck headed for the net. Wilson there, shoots, and he scores! Ron Wilson! Now they're gonna wave it off. And they're gonna call it offside. They're gonna wave it off and call it offside, and it doesn't mean a darn thing to the Blues. They're going to win it and move into a tie for first place with the Chicago Blackhawks at 74 points. So it's an offside call, but a second to go, they'll drop the puck, and the Blues will celebrate. And the Blues, with one more game remaining here on March 11th, have won 2 out of 3 here at the stadium. The puck is dropped, it's over, and the Blues score a huge victory here at Chicago Stadium over the Blackhawks. They congratulate Vincent Riendo. The Blues are in first place, tied with Chicago. And Brian Sutter is happy as any coach can be. The final score tonight, the St. Louis Blues.